This is the first message. And then understand. My first message, or the last if you want, is start from the standing point that whatever I want to tell you, I think A, and the guy to, or the girl to whom I am talking thinks B. Most likely, if there is a third person involved, he or she will think C. So, in order to get effective communication, which means I think it will be somewhere slide. What's the purpose of communication? To get things done. So how do we measure whether the communication is effective? The slide is nice, or two lines instead of three? No. If the job is done properly.
What happens next?
What happens next? Very simple. There is no other KPI, there is no other measurement role. This is real life situation. Unfortunately, 4 years ago. So the situation goes like this. I am all preparing for the past. Of course, the names are kind of mixed or changed, but basically we are talking about the persons who are present here. And of course, we try to avoid the names, but more or less we will see what is happening with the USA. So this is 12 noon. So I'm working at home preparing for the class, and I understand that there is something missing. And I said mail. Sorry, Victoria, for not understanding, but I will try to understand. So, OB book, Robin's page, 5:10 to 5:12. To be honest, I am also not very good in communication. In fact, opposite, quite bad in communication. This is why I try, and please, whenever you feel that I'm not direct or correct enough, please let me know, because apparently I do send 20 emails per night, not per day. So sometimes, unfortunately, what I mean is not always understood from the other side. So feel free, I won't feel offended, I won't feel nervous. I'd be much happier if you ask me now, please, what did you mean by this? Then if we have open space, we wander around. Here I was quite, let's say, precise. From page 5:10 to 5:12, there are two cases. Racing for success and politics of backstabbing. Would you consider to scan this and, if possible, send me two separate PDF files? Ideally, word. Okay. So now we are talking 2.5 hours later. B will send you the cases. I said, excellent, thank you. Now B sends the case. Look at the case. Is there a problem?
Yes.
What is the problem? Well, it's not half of the case, but it's only one question. For
questions
to know.
Missing.
This case actually has four questions. So this was sent, two and something. So quite a frequent task. So now I'm still working at home. My starting point class will start at 6 p.m. And I see 5 o'clock, I see another cases, and now I go to completely mad with my famous sentence, when a refrigerator is not a refrigerator. So guys, I say it is done, but it's not done. Attention to detail and precision, and very simple message. Now I see. Basically, I write to those guys who were involved in this story that on the first case there is only one question, in the book there are four. On the second case there are two questions, in the book there are four. I don't think it's fair because people pay 4,600 euros to be in this class. So that same class, 30 students, paid $120,000. Divide by number of classes and we will see what's the value of that one afternoon. Where we are playing something completely stupid. Whoever was involved was not playing with himself, with herself, with myself. Basically, we are playing with our customers. Paid seriously, we don't come here out of charity or because we like it. Plain and simple. One case. And in good case scenario, this would have been a historical case, and we don't have anything new. But we come to
the comfort zone. The problem is that the world is putting us continuously outside of our comfort zone, and we retreat quickly back into our comfort zone as much as we can because it's costly, because it's obvious, because we feel better, understandable. That means we are not riding the change. We are resisting the change and we are suffering for the change. Some changes are good, some are bad. It's not change is beautiful because it's change. It's that if you are not running, it is running you. So we got this guy from California, which is now has 10 million students and is not a professor. And this thing is saying, I think professors in the future will be very different. Because it's not somebody who thinks he can teach us something. There will be professors who don't teach. I like the idea of coaches. Individual. Think about the time you don't have to spend in class and coming to physically here, your students, and they can employ all that time, if they are smart, in one-to-one mentoring with a group of coaches. Maybe that's more effective. I don't know. Maybe not. But
yeah, I tend to agree with that because
things change.
You should do it from home.
They all do it from home.
Yeah, home from your home. In the slippers, you know? Time that you waste coming, going, traffic, and stuff like that can be used for meaningful stuff.
And I'll give you an additional dimension. This is in the normal world we live. Think about Africa, Asia. Things where there is nothing. With technology, you can have now a link with a solar battle to a computer, and you can jumpstart 3 generations of lack of knowledge, and so famine and hunger and trouble, giving education to a new generation of people at nearly zero cost. This is going to happen in the next 10 years, I think.
That's already happening. Intel and Motorola already have long-distance Wi-Fi links, which are used in Africa in faraway locations, almost over the horizon Wi-Fi.
Why should I spend 25,000 euros per semester to come to my business school, which is what it costs, when I can maybe do it from home with the same quality or a different quality but different setup? I don't know, I'm just challenging my own future, okay? So, any answer on this?
Motivator.
Absolutely. In fact, we have something said there. How does a leader motivate you? What motivates you? Has something to do with the people you want to follow. Leadership, a leader is somebody you want to follow. Apart from
great leaders always motivate to one single thing, making us believe that we are an equal part of his decision.
Correct. Or part of the game.
Yes.
Integrity.
Well, I don't know how to say it otherwise, but having a soul,
having
compassion. Yes, compassion towards the people, employees, their problems, you know, accidents happen.
Caring.
Yeah, caring. Yeah.
Caring. Empathy.
Empathy. Yeah.
Nice. Now let's flip sides, and we would ask something else.
Please name a leader. Who do you think is a leader? Skip me.
What do you want?
Benito Mussolini.
One name.
Benito Mussolini. To be honest,
he's a leader because he made the train to him on time. And that was a big success in Italy because they were like 3 hours behind and he made something happen. Was it by decree, by policy, or by passion? How did he do it? I don't know.
He did a few other things, but I put it there. Fine. Accept everything.
Duke stands for the Duchess. Yasmin asked me if business leaders generally, but we say leaders, what is the first thing which comes to your mind?
Philosophy.
Steve Jobs.
Okay, next, Jobs.
Steve Jobs.
Well, yeah, leader defending in which term? Like a leader of a country or a leader in a sort of a
state? The first thing which pops up to your mind when we say leader.
Exactly. First thing comes to your mind.
My case, it would be Nikola Tesla, for example.
Oh, wow. Okay, Nikola Tesla.
Mukhayetov, you just put Tesla. Put just M for Mukhayetov. This is CEO of one big.
Put what?
M. M for Mukhayetov, or you can. No, this is a new one below Tesla. So you put Mukhayetov, which is MUKAETOV. This is leader of the largest company here. Someone else said Winston Churchill. Winston Churchill, right?
Blood, sweat, and tears.
Sure. Okay, anyone else?
Obama. Gandhi.
Obama. Before he, because he's born in Mexico. Otherwise, he would be. Tito.
Tito.
Excellent. Obama.
Gandhi.
Tito.
Gandhi,
somebody
said Gandhi.
Yes,
I'm saying it. Putin. Prime Minister of this country. Nikola Gruevski, Prime Minister of Republic of
Macedonia. How
do you write that? G-R-U-E-V-S-K. Please try to stay politically correct. Okay, I think the names are enough. Okay, so on the left hand side, we've defined the main.
We only mentioned only male.
Yes. No, this is 10% Margaret Thatcher. Margaret Thatcher, excellent. I just think a somewhere between.
Mother Teresa.
So guys, what we have here on the left hand side, we've defined the main features of leader, which included without cases, please just join us, we can which included compassion. Guys, could you kill the phones? Did you want to turn it off? So we had things like compassion, like caring for others, like authority, like what else? Listening skills, communication skills. These were basically the Klaus voted that these are most important things that we expect or features of the leader. On the right hand side, we have leaders identified by the same class, where we have one warrior, or at least not so compassionate person, which was Mussolini. Then you have Churchill, who was also, you said the most important sentence. He was, I don't know how was he behaving with his cabinet members or party members, but basically he was prime minister in wartime. So I'm not sure that he was really compassionate and having time for everything. Then we had like Putin. Putin and democracy and compassion, I'm not that sure. Then we have Tito, who was still a warrior, communist leader, actually not very compassionate. And we have Tesla, who was basically not the leader at all, because he didn't have organization to lead, so he was leading himself.
Well, he had some people to lead, and he left the humanity into 21st century.
Yes, but personally he died in poverty in 1943 and not known by anyone, and he was discovered I don't know how many years later.
Yeah, okay.
So let us say that on the right hand side we have like three quarters of the identified leaders who do not match the features mentioned on the other side. This in OB is called cognitive dissonance theory. Our beliefs are one thing and our perception is another thing. How do we solve this?
This is a very important start. We started in, after 10 minutes, we are highlighting discrepancies in our own structure of beliefs. So, What do you like in a leader?
Not necessarily discrepancies. These are older types of leaders. Tough people for tough times. Today,
Steve Jobs?
Different times.
Yeah. Can I build a little bit, just a few minutes on this? We decided for this class today to skip the theory completely. And when Vittorio started, he said, what do you think, whether leaders are born or made? And this is the first leadership theory, which is trait theories, which suggests that leaders are born. Then it was built on the second generation of theories, suggesting that there are two types of leaders, people-oriented, task-oriented. And basically, more or less, you have, though you have identified more task-oriented leaders than people, because Mother Teresa and...
people.
Yes, but people, but two people oriented, and maybe Gandhi, yes, but the majority were task-oriented. Just one more sentence, if I can finish this. But the third important thing is the so-called situational group of theories, which suggests that you cannot expect the same behavior in different situations. Churchill probably would have acted differently in a peace, in times of peace, than he acted in times of war. Marian Lajiev would probably be different leader when we enroll 400 students, and probably different when we have 200 students. Sorry, Victor.
Actually, what I would say, like, it depends on the culture, whether national culture, organizational culture, what type of leader is suitable for that culture.
I'm very happy you mentioned this, and I hope that we'll finish the project we started in this call with Anna and the others, which is called, I don't know if the others know, organizational alignment. So alignment between the culture of the leader, the values of the organization, and formal parts of the strategy. Didn't you want to add?
Yes, I want to say it depends what you're leading. I mean, they were leading wars, some of them inventions, some of them organizations, and they need to... Yes. Maybe sometimes take a different priorities towards these criteria we give them or features.
A very interesting point to highlight, in my opinion, is that we had a 5 minutes discussion on what do we like, what is highlights, characteristics of leadership, and the things we like from our point of view to see in somebody taking the leadership position. And we have very good ideas there. It's pretty clear, and it's all very in the inspiring section. Okay, then the same people, it's quite, it's a good proxy, the same people we identify as tell me a person that for you.
Okay, but we didn't have the consensus, we didn't reach consensus for this. For instance, for me it is not important to be compassionate for a good leader, so we didn't reach consensus, so that is why also here we have some discrepancy, and here as well.
Yes, it is true. What is we did this exercise last time, and we had a very similar result. It was even more clear, actually.
And we get people from the Ministry of Economy and Ministry of Education.
Okay, but they prefer authority, or their, you know, formal methods and formal styles.
Yes,
much more appreciated.
Exactly true. But what is interesting is that it's us. The way we are built is that we like those things. We like those things, and then we like people, Mussolini, Churchill, as iconic figures. I see discrepancy here. What do you think? Don't you see anything that has to do with them?
The main difference.
Mentioning that doesn't mean that we like them.
I'm using force. It's force. It's intimidation factor. Everything is
like beating people.
If we consider state, what is a state? State is a force.
You don't deal with the state.
The president leads you by force, not by general consensus, because he didn't ask all the people what they want, whether they want to pay taxes or what.
I agree.
So it appears that the leaders, world leaders, are there by some sort of force, of intimidation, coercion.
Apropos your comment on the leaders we have mentioned, which lack practically all the characteristics, except for this and that, we mentioned them as leaders, which doesn't mean that we like them. That probably means that we could follow them if we lived in those times. So let's not mix in liking or agreeing with somebody.
I take your word. You would follow them.
If necessary.
If you follow them, to me that's leadership, and that's your, even worse, it's worse, it's your choice. I'm just trying to highlight a point that we like those things, and then we think those guys are great.
We don't think they're great, but
no, no, just to speak of your leaders. No one said anything about liking them.
I mean, so for example, if I'm coherent, they always said, I don't know. You know Yunus from Grammenbank? You know this guy? Who's the guy who's giving basically free credit to Bangladesh women who have zero income? He's a cooperative bank.
Yeah.
Cooperative bank. He's a big, big, well-known figure today, like a Nobel Prize for Peace, because he's lending money to the people that nobody on the planet will lend money to. Unemployed women in Bangladesh. That's where it started.
So
basically, and he's got those features. It's very well known. Okay, and he
is lending.
He created a bank.
What interest?
Affordable interest rate. You mean
affordable?
No, not for free. He gets.
So basically,
normal interest rate.
If the poor people do not pay,
that's not what happens. They pay.
Yeah, but if they can't, he makes bills.
Basically,
he owns.
What he's saying is different. He's lending money to people no bank on the planet will give money to, on the assumption that they will never get the money back. Okay? He's doing the opposite. He says, I think you're going to give me the money back, and that happens. Turning the problem upside down, so because those people, especially those women, are the women that control the money, whatever money that is in the family. They are the only ones who have control of the purse and whatever small it is, and they have immense pride and drive to pay back the loan in order to get maybe some elementary education for a kid. Something like that. It happens. So you're just circumventing from upside down the concept of banking. It's very Grameen Bank. Check it out. It's a very famous story now over the planet. That's a leader that has those features: innovation, compassion, people. Nobody knows him. Nobody mentions him. And we go for Tito, Mussolini, and stuff like that. So to me, it's just an opinion. It looks like some kind of contradiction in the things we want from people and the things we are ready to follow in somebody. Don't you see some of this?
Well, not really, because if we were allowed, let's say we as a group,
if we started awarding,
you would have to choose someone with those characteristics.
Sure,
if you're given a choice. But most of the time you're not given a choice. For example, let's say presidential campaign in the United States, they have 50 candidates for Miss America, but they have only two candidates for president.
Correct.
So, which one would you choose?
Well, from the middle perspective?
It depends on the choice. You have a choice, but most of the time, no.
If I may add a few words in there, we're talking about leadership of what? People alike, in general, or a fictive prospect. Because if you look at geese, you've got one geese that usually flies and all the others follow behind it. Once that one gets all tied up, a new one comes up and a new one flies and leads the way for the geese. If you look at sheep, a flock of sheep, who's the leader? The guy that holds a stick? The dog or the ram? Who's the leader in that pack? Because they all lead something, but some lead by decree, some lead by power, and some lead by wealth, by compassion. So which one do you take as a leader in that pack?
I see the point. It's just that it's not interesting what I think. It's interesting what we decide to follow.
Exactly. Like I said, the sheep, the dog, the ram, or the sheep itself.
Okay, because we said that we have different styles. And then you begged a little bit, you, when I said you are in the group, when We popped up the dictionary, there is a different thing. Okay, now let me rephrase the question. Who is your role model? Whom would you follow?
Are we talking about business, political?
No, you personally, but whom would you follow?
Whatever. A role model.
Whom would you follow?
It depends on the situation.
Well, for example, the situation is today, Wednesday, 7th of November 2012. We go to war.
No, I don't want to leave.
In fact, the open chapter is called Leadership and Trust.
Okay, but that is not your role model.
Whom would you trust? Whom do you trust? Mother Teresa, you don't trust her?
Yes, but the question is who is your role model? Yes. Not who you follow.
Okay, then I rephrase the question. Yeah. Whom would you follow?
Jobs. In order to become like him or her? Or
today, so tomorrow. Today you can choose jobs, for instance. Whom would you follow? Today you can vote for a different political party. Whom do you vote for? Who is your...
So basically two things, following leadership and following the president doesn't mix together.
Yes, you're completely right.
They don't mix together.
This is the beauty of it.
We don't have to like the president, but we have to like our superiors or someone like that.
Okay,
so if we mix the two topics...
Okay, if I'm making this a vague situation, Venice, sorry for... Then let me rephrase the question. Who is your role model? Like it is on the slide.
Role model is somebody...
Like Mother Teresa, Putin,
and leader.
Yes, completely right. So.
Neither of them.
Neither anybody can you name? Jobs. Yasmina said someone she trusts.
I think Yasmina's point is the best one. You
but
trust,
can you be more specific, like...
Who would you trust? Someone who cares, Grisha.
Yeah, but this is already on the left board,
example.
Right? Example, give me example. Steve Jobs. Yeah. You would trust Steve Jobs. Do you know Steve Jobs?
No.
Okay. Is that right about, sorry. I can first about. Ladies first, sorry, I was in
Yusuf Rosso. Steve Jobs has compassion and care for
first
people.
First, let's define the difference between a role model, an idol, a leader. We are mixing up things. Yes. If you are asking which leader, who would be chosen as a leader from a person that we know,
okay.
It should be a person that we trust, as Yasmina said, for example.
Okay, this is the definition of the question.
Yeah. So actually, personally, we cannot all of us have one leader but the one stated. Those are different leaders. So the question, as I assumed, is, for example, a good leader might be the dean of School of Architecture, Araneo. She's a perfect leader. She was given something small. She just needed it to something very successful nowadays.
It's
a role model, you trust her, she goes to challenge.
But I don't agree that it is role model. Role model is somebody that you would like to become like.
Yes.
But I can follow somebody, but I might not like
yes.
To become as he or she is. So.
So actually, we should choose somebody who believes in their traits, in their character, in the all the characteristics that the person has.
Well, that means that we have to understand the leader as somebody who is a value with a proven presence of our individual culture of understanding the term.
This is a rare example of having all these tools in the
closet. Wi-Fi,
and pen and paper. Probably two thirds don't have including me. So I'm really excited about this.
Someone who can integrate different people in the organization into a whole.
And the leader applied different leadership styles in different trees.
Super! Can you bring here for the leadership style for a second?
My role model is Paul Krugman, Nobel Prize winner. And I would like to become like him. That is role model. No, I don't need to know. I would like to become as him.
Exchange.
Sorry?
Exchange.
No Nobel Prize winner
in
economy. Yeah.
He was a professor, I hope.
Yes, absolutely. Which means I would like to develop further my career as a professor.
Nobel Prize.
You can be.
Not
as a leader.
Okay, so we have no Nobel Prize winner Paul Krugman and Steve Jobs so far. And Victoria Lemayo. Not bad so far. Someone mentioned leadership styles, right? Can you take those?
By the way, you want to know what's the perfect role model?
So I need to go for internship.
Perfect role
model? Yes, which is a very good
role. All our families are social. So before we as parents fuck it up, before that happens,
Right. Should I bleep that part out of my tape?
So it's for eternal use, you don't need to bleep.
Where are these videos, boss? Where are they? Somewhere just to yes. We use. You see this movie?
That's well. For me? Yes.
Quarterback with him to his next team. So he's actually motivating him, reeling him as like a fisher. Like, you know.
Was he successful?
In the end, yes.
In the end of the movie. What about now?
With the player, yes. In the other movie,
What about now? At the end of this conversation. My question is, at the end of that conversation, he's doing what you say, he's trying to convince him to behave in a certain way because he should be the leader of the team. If he wants to be the leader of the team, he's got to be having some behaviors, which is doesn't have, he's playing in an egoistic way. Did he manage to succeed, in your opinion, to convince him to change his behavior? So explaining why and explaining the philosophy of the game and everything? Was he successful?
No. It's obvious that he didn't because the quarterback left.
Yes. But just sometimes, come on.
Sometimes planting the seed is enough.
Yes.
Okay. Later on, the person gets to rethink.
But then he played the other quarterback, as you remember in the movie. He played the other quarterback next. So he's very upset. At the end,
he chose this one.
Yes. But that's a few months later. In the meantime, he's playing the other quarterback. So has he been efficient in his coaching, communication, leadership approach? Then did he convince the other guy that he was right?
No.
He goes away pissed off. Are they friends? Did he trust in one another? Are they trusting one another?
Not
at all. So one way of judging, you are right, of course, but one way of judging, especially communication from my point of view, is by the end product. Actually, it's the only way, but I think it's a way, which means what happens as a result of my communication, or as a result of my action. If he's behaving in this certain way, then I've been effective. If it doesn't, then I'm not ineffective. What about the other guy, the bully guy?
It was the real estate agency, yes. And real estate agents has to be ruthless, which I have first-hand experience. Not being a real estate agent,
so it's
not
being a winner. It's real. it's a bit Hollywoodized, but it's and real.
Jack Lemmon, as an older guy who still has some remains of humanity in him, in the end he's defeated. So yes. The end of the movie
it's
is
a terrible movie. This movie is extreme. Yes. It's
and I couldn't watch it from beginning to the end, yes. But I simply got some of the experiments.
It's a tragic movie because it's giving you the worst of modern aggressiveness in society, the worst. That's why it's a famous, actually it's a theater play, transposed into a movie. But what about effectiveness? If you judge your action by their results, do you think it's been effective?
Yes.
Did they get the message?
Yes. And they didn't leave the room, meaning they agreed.
Well, by the way, I've been in a business myself, which was investment banking, where this kind of thing, I've seen it every day.
Is he a leader? I mean, because we are talking about leaders.
Yes. Now we're moving towards effectiveness, or what we should do with our people, how we should behave with our subordinates, how we should behave with our friends, how we should be behaving towards our bosses. We are in the middle of the transmission chain, so how we can be effective. If somebody comes in and gives you that message, the first message, maybe it takes months before you take, you know, even if you plant the seed, it takes months before you start soul searching yourself and understand maybe it's right, and then, so one day you're going to have results. If you want action, I'm not defending that behavior. I'm asking you, which one is getting there? Is it clear? You have, I mean, it's abuse, yes. It's hard, it's bordering on the unacceptable. But then,
it is only part of the story.
It always depends. You always have circumstances underlying everything. For example, let's say in the second movie, he comes in and he starts bashing with them and bullying them and stuff like that. For example, if you work with people that have no choice, no possibility to find another job and stuff like that. They will sit, be quiet, agree and stuff like that. But if you have someone who has other opportunity, you're going to say,
fuck you.
Yeah, of course.
But that's fine. That's understandable, I agree. The point is, why did this happen? We don't know, but there must have been some background where maybe these guys were not selling what they should have been selling or something. Well, must have been some shortcoming why this happens.
Those are the circumstances.
Those are the circumstances.
Of course.
So that means that if this guy, we might dislike him as much as we want, and we all do. But my only point is, if we have a problem, and the problem is contingent, is now we have, I don't know, fewer students. What are we going to do about it? Plant seeds? Of course we should be planting seeds. But at the same time, there is something that needs to be done yesterday in order to preserve our organization and stuff like that. I don't know, maybe it's the wrong example.
Supply chain management. There are no more examples we said at the very beginning.
I don't think that... Yes, you might not be with me, but in the first movie we saw, it's a nice movie, very teaching one, but this movie goes together with something in the background. And this is called visual thinking. And what goes in the background? In the background goes one very famous historical painting from Ben-Hur. Do you know that we're in this movie?
Which is
from,
we know it's historical.
Yes, of course. And the main person in that scene is a leader of the Jewish people. And this is the famous race in which he has to win so he can take his people and lead them out and take them whenever it's, and so on and so on. Together with that concept of leadership goes the other one, contemporary one, Al Pacino's concept of contemporary approach towards leadership. So when they contrast those two types of leadership on one single stage, then by the power of our visual thinking, we have both models present in our minds. So in the first movie, we were much more able to define and to conclude what the type of profile of a leader is, because it goes
together with wiping, with killing, with having a pure physical battle for your purpose, for what you want, and you know that you have to reach and go to. And the other one is democratic one, is approach like a coach to explain, to say, to define its place. And so we have two concepts in one single movie. One is this Ben-Gur concept of a hero, that have to win the race because his people are waiting for his win.
Yes.
They have to wait. He has to win because the goal is with your people will. They have to believe you. You will be a leader this way. Or the other one is
convincing
you that you are a part of a game.
Yes.
And in this game, you have a goal.
Everything you said, I agree with.
There is also the question of presentation. For example, in the second movie, you have grown up people that said without all the insults and stuff like that. Because it says that he probably thinks they're morons, they can't understand normal world words, so he's going to insult them, curse them, stuff like that. And everyone has self-respect,
of course,
face and stuff like that. So
this is extremely, by our, especially our European culture, this is absolutely unacceptable behavior. And my experience, I've seen it happen for years in American investment banking. One of the reasons why I left, it's, for us it's clearly unacceptable, but that's not the point. The point is we have a problem. How do we deal with the problem? So, let's move away from defining leadership and stuff. Let's see how do we deal with a problem with this contingent. They got a game or they got some business problem on the other side.
I will put another point of view. First, maybe you know by Niccolo Machiavelli, it's not important the what asset you use, but the goal. And
the goal justifies the means.
Of course. This is maybe what we believe. I want to say that now in this situation, for example, just for the university, before we have the strategic meeting, the first one, nobody came to participate in the non, let's say, in those actions that they don't need to participate like obligatory. But after the first strategic meeting, everybody come to the department heads meeting. Everybody finish their obligations towards, I don't know, goals on specific types of actions. And now everything is done in due time. So, Maria wants to say about this carrot and about the stick story. And before we didn't have this kind of story on this first strategic meeting, we didn't have the results. Now, even we decline some benefits for the employees, we have better results.
What is your conclusion?
Conclusion? The conclusion, people, if they want to be somewhere, they must follow the goals of the company. Otherwise, we are not kind of some kind of entertainment office here, and we need to do our jobs in the best way as somebody imagine or plan, and we must put everything from ourselves to achieve this goal. If not, are not our places somewhere else. And that's my opinion.
Okay, thank you very much.
I would abstract myself from university. No, that is not the point of the discussion. But in the second case, when we say there was some bullying or pressure and so on, I still think that the idea there was also to motivate the workers. No, maybe the way in which he tried to motivate workers was not that good one, but he was trying to motivate them through showing what they can achieve, like status in a society to have this expensive watch and so on. But in that case, you have to be careful because maybe you don't have the same kind of culture, role model, you know, you don't share the same future. Maybe for me, the expensive watch is not any motivating factor. Yeah. So I think he was trying to motivate the workers there. I won't say that there was just pressure or bullying. He was really trying to motivate workers. And there are different ways to motivate workers, but he was trying to motivate them.
By imposing himself as a role model that
maybe they, you know, saying that expensive car is a
Can I ask one thing? Nick said that the second thing was very motivating. Can you vote? How many of you would rather work for the second guy?
One, two, three, four.
For the second guy, you're fine.
Maria, sorry, but the problem is that they share different values. So if he didn't manage to, I don't know, to grow same values in that company, then, you know, he cannot not motivate them in that way.
But then it still doesn't come to the vote. So how many of you at this very moment, let's say you are at the job interview, so you can choose A or B. B is the guy who fired people. How many of you would choose that organization?
Only this young, please take it person.
Maria is considering? Five. The others, choose the other guy? The others who would go for Alvacino?
Yeah.
Please don't be biased, ladies, especially because
the no, both are
good. Yeah, choose all the children in both or you're in the bottom. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 to 4, where are the others?
Undecisive.
The third one. The third one. You participate for the first time, so please try for us to win. No, for the second. Take records. So,
Professor, please feel free. What I was going to say about these two examples, explaining what the leadership is, the second reminds me of, several decades ago. When Yugoslavia was one of the best basketball teams in the world.
Yes.
And then in Yugoslavia newspapers, sport newspapers, there was some kind of evaluation of the coaches of the representations of Yugoslavian basketball. And they said, okay, the best one was Aca Nikolic. He was called the professor because he was a professor of basketball at sports university. And he was a scientific oriented, and he was one of the best experts for basketball in Europe and in the world. The second was Novosel or whatever, Novosel and that. But in the first four, there was the coach of Rabotnichi, the team from Skopje, Larry Lazanecic. Very unexpected because the evaluation for everybody was, you know, this the knowledge, the and for Lazanecic was only the way of motivation. He doesn't know how to play, how the basketball was played. He doesn't know anything about basketball, but he has the skills of motivating the players.
Why would you put Lazanecic?
Lazanecic is the second. Why? Lazanecic. I can remember that when the TV when the basketball matches were put on the TV and they put the microphone in the time of time break, they put the microphone within the players and the coaches. And from the other side, you can hear Aca Nikolic. Well, if the players are going to play like this, you should and the Lazanecic, when they put the microphone within the Lazanecic team, he said, shall I speak in English because it's something more
coach in Macedonia, and there was this video playing when he motivates his team on conditioning. So they are in Kruševo, it is winter, half meter of snow all around, and Dudo Kondras he motivated his team. So he drives a white Audi 80 from the old days and they should try to catch him. Running in the snow.
About those who doesn't know, why was Lazarevich so high on this TRT? Because Rabotnički came to fourth place in all those teams about Pakistan, Zvezda, Jugoplastika, and so on. And without any players that can compete with these players from Belgrade, Zagreb, and Split.
I think personally you need to have sense as what is right for the people at the right moment. So it's again about alignment and contingency and situational kind of theories of knowing what to do at the exact moment, knowing what people need to hear and what they need to actually do at the right moment. Maybe the second video comes up as a very crude when you look at the video, but you have to have the in mind the end result or what he achieves with the company or what he achieves with the team. So it's just doing the right thing at the right time, I guess.
Well, you can also go different strokes for different folks.
Yeah,
the second type of leadership, if there is nothing on the market, if there is nothing on the market, no, nothing sold, no houses, no buildings, nothing. His motivation is lost.
Is
so the main price are those leads.
Is that the case, we think? How can't he say, maybe he's wrong, but we don't know. He says, I go out with your leads, that is with your information, and do myself $15,000.
I doubt that.
We don't know.
He does not have the connections, the network to do
it's
that.
It's only three.
But apparently, he made some money in the past. Exactly.
Okay,
well,
can I ask a question, a really simple question? I mean, we talk a lot about leadership. I'm going to talk about two people or two companies, Jamie Dimon and the Lehman Brothers. What kind of leaders and leadership went on there?
I work for Jamie Dimon.
Okay, well, how would you rate him?
He's a great leader.
Why was it so much in the newspaper? And we were all about bad leaders.
Well, before getting that bad dress, he managed to become the most important banker on this planet. So he must have been doing something reasonably right.
You're his shareholder.
Something good for him. Maybe he's not. He was the CEO of.
But where is he now? Where is he now?
He's still the most important banker on the planet.
Is he?
Yes, he's the CEO of JP Morgan, the only bank in the United States that can buy another bank.
Another country, most probably. To be more precise,
he's exactly my age, by the way. And I had the opportunity to work with him. Very sharp guy. He had an excellent mentor, which was Sandy Weil, and extremely sharp and knowledgeable about the business.
Which method did he use? The first, the second.
You?
Yes.
Oh, I think he's probably more inclined towards the second. But I don't know him that well, to be precise, but. Created substantial debt, but we shouldn't confuse the person, I think, with the business. The business is, these banks are too big to be managed effectively in an intelligent way for society. They can only be managed effectively for some people. There is them. Okay, I'm very much against that situation, so maybe we share the same view. But if you ask me about the person, I think he is great, because of all the banks, of all the bank leader before 2008, is the only one standing with a bigger, more solid institution under his belt. And everything else has been either brought into public hand or receivership or bought by somebody else. He's the one buying. So his bank is by far the most solid. They bought Washington Mutual, they bought their stands for $1. Every time the bank goes back in America, the Federal Reserve calls it, they please buy this bank and take it out of my bank. Stuff like that. So it's the business which we should be very critical of. The way we build monsters that nobody can control and nobody understands. And then we all have to pay the bill for that. That's it. But that's a different question. So
okay. Another question. What would be most important here on the slides? What we have is basically what has been discussed here And I believe Anna maybe gave the best wrap-up, that it depends on the situation. These are all situational theories, and there are various, but we wouldn't go into details now, but basically, there's a positive series in 7 delegated 10, and on the lower, it goes like this. And on the lower angle, we have also the another dimension, which is called Kent-Blanchard's theory, which reflects to followers' readiness and ability to actually follow. So the different situations provide different leadership types. Can I ask you another question, which is, what is the most important element of leadership in the 21st century?
Vision.
Can I ask you simply a question? The coffee came in, was brought in. There was not enough time for Irene and Vicky to actually distribute the coffee, or they were polite enough not to disturb the class. How was coffee distributed to everyone? Everybody has coffee.
Like yeah. Fourth way of production. Assembly line.
You get two women that are really good housewives and they want to care for the rest.
Teamwork. Did anyone formally said Yasmina, Lila, and Melora, you will be the team?
No, I am.
Self-organization?
My God.
They were the first
one. You should just do this business master. You speak so much, you can finish it in 18 months. Self-managed team. So what happened?
It depends on the task. If you know the task and if it's familiar to you and the people that are that is the shoot, yes, that are should perform the task, and if they know each other and if they know their circumstances and everything.
Know each other. This is a good point.
Yeah. Excellent point. Yeah. And she said it's a familiar task.
Familiar task.
Excellent. But basically what happened is that in this small group, okay, we more or less know each other, so it was not completely a group of strangers. But when Venera made a move here and passed over sugar, we made eye contact, she understood that I don't have sugar for my coffee. But basically without any particular thing, which is not happening very often in the USCS. We managed that everybody received what was needed. The job was done well without any serious breakthroughs, and we worked as a team. 21st century is all about teams.
You should change business.
I hope not to be honest.
Okay, now we're gonna do something funny. Now we're gonna do something physical. That's why we invited so many girls. We're gonna do something funny and crazy, which is the following. You said we've done it well because you are familiar with the task. Let's do something for which you are not familiar with the task and see what happens. Now, let's do this exercise, which is gonna, you just need a little bit of physical participation. That means standing up. So when I say go, I'll give you 1 minute to solve a problem. 1 minute. And will be one leader or a captain that will tell us when the job is finished, we are clocking, and see what happens. Okay? So, the exercise works like this. You have all to, everybody stands up in the middle of this room, and when I say go, you have to do something which I'm going to be telling you in 1 second, without talking and without writing. You cannot talk to one another, and you cannot write anything. So basically, I'm depriving you of the resources to reach the budget. When you want, when Marian wants the budget done, the first thing we ask is, okay, you need the resources to achieve that budget. Don't pretend I do it without. Okay, let's see what happens. We must be fast. Okay?
okay? So really fast, move out and exercise.
We should come there in the middle of the
physical
contact.
From the board to wherever we can to align ourselves in one line. So you cannot speak, you cannot do anything, okay? You cannot speak, you cannot write. Everybody should put itself in line, and we have 60 seconds roughly. The youngest there, the oldest here, and he goes now. Somebody said, I did this well, the coffee thing, because we are familiar with this.
No, not familiar. You think that everything is going to develop on the left and on the right, and everything was just by that.
Yeah.
I stay in the middle.
There is a theory.
You see, that's the
theory
to assume the age of a woman. So,
it's an emotional aspect.
Yeah.
It's an emotional
aspect.
It's an emotional aspect.
Stand there and just hope.
It's emotional aspect.
They sort them out by
the end. I found out that Coca wanted to be younger.
The fear is that we really don't know if they're 6 months old or younger. So that's why we bunched up together and had money and said three mistakes. But the other ones, they were okay.
But it's from my point of view, it was pretty good. Because how many people we have here? Like 20?
32.
Okay, so we made 10% mistakes, just for mathematicians and experts, not me. 10% mistakes in 45 seconds. Now, so we give you a task that you don't expect, number one. Secondly, what happens?
You're on fire.
Much better than that. I give you a task that you don't expect. So, bam, out of the blue. Arjen can think, I want this done yesterday. Okay, which myself out, and you will make zero mistake in more or less time, same time. You will take in.
Oh, they said ask, and first visualize, and ask. And then ask, well, you can visualize it.
Okay.
That's my way of visual thinking.
Okay, fine.
And yes, that's a different approach, but effective one, of
fine.
Course.
Fine. Is the managerial approach we are looking at? Is I give you a task and I take away resources to reach that task in the normal, usual, ordinary, easy, habitudinary way. Okay?
I do it on purpose. And I take away the resource. And then I take away a second resource, which is maybe, okay, we cannot talk, let's put, I write down my age. No. With younger people, I do it sometimes, I take away lots, I do it with like this, or blind, all sorts of things. Result is normally positive. Not always, but normally positive. And which degree of positiveness can we attach to this? Did we solve an unexpected problem without resources? Yes or no?
Yes.
And with a degree of success, is that satisfactory to you?
10% forwards. 10% plus 10%
error. 10%
error
in 45 seconds. It's irrelevant. According to my vision of the world, which is Pareto, is irrelevant.
Yeah.
Totally irrelevant. That means A minus.
Yeah,
10% A minus, B plus.
No, more than B plus. More than B plus, because it's done. What's relevant has been done. Suppose I give you, instead of 1 minute, 5 minutes. Let's think about this. Because we are A minus, we are not perfect.
Yes. What would be?
Straight A.
What would be the result if I give you 5 minutes?
It would be 99%.
No, without asking, the result would be the same.
With the same rule, without asking,
the result would have been the same.
No,
I would have been wrong. I would have been 100%.
Correct. Yeah, if we had more time, if I had time to think, to analyze, to look, I would stand in front of him.
Okay.
Not beside. Behind.
What is my point here? Okay, let's agree with them.
Because I know that he's older than me.
Well then,
but it was faster just lined up as well. He left and then.
Not enough time to analyze. Fantastic. I like this. Not enough time to analyze. Perfect. That's my perfect.
You don't think things make ways. Wait, Russia, you're gonna make a mistake.
Yes, but my point is better.
1 minute.
Is I give you 5 minutes, which is, and then you do 100% perfection. Fine. How much increase in resources I gave you in order for you to reach a 10% improvement?
For me, it's just time.
500%.
500% additional resource time. To achieve a 10% improvement. So why on the planet do we care about having a 10% improvement in this?
Well, it looks like you don't need to have it perfect, just good enough.
And good enough is A minus is super good. Because the amount of resources, meaning time, effort, tired, money, equity that you need to invest into something to have it perfect is absolutely disconnected with the effectiveness of the final result. Because thanks God the world is Pareto, and Pareto rules the planet. Not Obama.
Those
Pareto.
Perfect.
Italians or
Back in the 70s, General Motors made a lot of cars in Detroit. And their assembly line went at a specific speed, which meant there were a lot of mistakes. Honda, on the other side, in Japan, ran it a little differently, a little slower. What was the problem? GM had a lot of errors in their cars, Honda did not. This is the case. If you slow down, if you give them time to assemble what you're doing, you're not going to make mistakes. If you rush it to get the production done, you'll make mistakes. 5%, 7%, 10%.
Yes.
Another remark?
It's possible.
In the first movie we saw with Al Pacino, I saw it several times. It's a nice movie. But one sequence again.
And everybody shows the other sequence, the motivation speech.
Yes, but there is, in one of the sequences, in one of the discussions, there is a theory of an unexpected bulb, which says that if something, in the middle of the game, if something changes immediately,
right.
Somebody drops the ball, somebody does something unexpected, then what happens? Nobody is thinking, everybody is acting because the main goal is in front of them. Then they are using everything from their resources to reach the goal, which means that critical situations or pulling things to the level of critical is very important for the motivation.
Yes.
That's the theory of unexpected ball. What to do if I drop it right now in your hands?
Yes.
That's the question.
You're right. The point is here that if you're building a bridge, you cannot be 95% right.
Mm.
okay? But here we're talking about managerial problems, dealing with people, dealing with our subordinates, dealing with my boss, achieving results. So we will see later in the discussion, I don't know when, but as soon as possible, that the question would be, are we doing, we do 100 things, of the 100, and a lot of workload, lots of stuff, tiring, demanding, whatever. Are we doing the things that are relevant to our goals? Or of those 100 things, how many are there that should not even be done or done later, if at all? Prioritization of what we do. This is key today, because we cannot do anything.
Prioritization. I give you a simple example. When we were in Dubai last year, we tried to visit some architecture studios or to see how those design studios are organized. Because all of the famous architects are there, all the famous studios, they are all there doing things. But when you're reading about portfolios of buildings, you're starting with what? For example, I was commissioned to design the building, but where is my name? It starts with, the main investor of the building is the one who does the financial plan of and the management plan and everything is this. Credits, money, finances, managing of the finances, construction, and at the end, the design of the building was commissioned too. The final thing is the design of the building. That's the list of the priorities in the 21st century. 100 years ago, at the beginning, for example, of the 20th century, the great importance was, who is commissioned to design the building? Me. If I am the great me, then everybody is good. I am on top. The teamwork in the architectural and construction field is of great importance. Of great importance. The design is below. Everything is beginning with the money. And who is going to give the money for construction?
21st century's money.
Yes.
And of course this is true.
But it does not influence the design. Don't misunderstand me. But to make design possible, to sell it, and to make money of it, you have to do this. Prioritize. On this list, you have to be down below. Just like in the Renaissance times, let me remind you, when Leonardo da Vinci was doing his CV, he's doing what? I can build what? Towers, houses, bridges, streets. I can heal people, I can do whatever, and I can paint a little bit.
You didn't consider yourself to be a great painter.
Yes, of course. But at the end, he says, and I am a painter a little bit.
This is Tim Chappell.
No, it's Michelangelo.
It's on prioritization. Maybe we ask the... Thank you very much for everyone.
Bravo.
Just the evolution of like half an hour.
Don't know right, my brother.
Добре, що сме синхронизирани.
Имам дрона?
Consider important in the last year,
12 months.
Don't think that Bane is a special case and he doesn't have the desk to write on it. He never writes on anything except on the computer, so he's no problem in using his CPU.
I'm doing it in my head.
Okay, Bane, what are your most important activities?
Well, quite a few, I'd say.
Yes, okay.
Learning. Yeah, I studied most of the different topics. Just a second.
One thing was parenting.
Yeah.
Okay, next thing?
Learning.
Studying like you or supporting your kids in
both? Supporting my kids with learning, of course. Actually, I'm studying personally. Okay.
And let's call it professional development for you.
Yeah. But not only my profession, in other topics also. I have a broad
that is like proficient
development and proficient
and personal enlargement.
Yeah.
If you don't understand anything from what I'm writing, don't be nervous because I don't understand either, but I pretend because it sounds like more
we know.
More like a professor thing that you write something on the blackboard, but actually.
Okay, then work, systems, servers.
Okay.
Work assisting colleagues, friends with problems.
Colleagues are equal friends or they're different?
Sorry?
Colleagues.
Yeah,
it's colleagues and friends. Colleagues equals friends or?
Yeah, colleagues equals friends. I consider my colleagues my friends, naturally.
Assisting.
Unless we get into a fight, then it gets one. That's another story.
Peers and friends.
Yeah.
So colleagues are not always friends. Because some.
Yeah.
And friends are not always colleagues.
Yeah.
Yes.
I think we're over.
Anything else?
All the natural things that people do, you know, shopping, home improvement,
shopping, home improvement meaning what?
Building something,
renovating
it. Yeah, building like, I don't know, fixing stuff at home or building different lights.
Not just things.
Okay, then what did you say? Okay. Anyone else would like to share the experience, or you get something that changing the car, fixing car.
Actually, I do work on my car also, so then that, let's say
hobby. That's a hobby. Anyone else would like to share?
Yes, of course.
Okay.
In general, not by example. I can say this, that I have managed to provide maximum balance between my personal expectations and previously evaluated limitations or abilities from the others, including colleagues, family, friends, everything. And all of that is based on self-evaluation.
This was so professor said that you couldn't follow the whole thing.
Yeah,
so
okay.
Balance between
my expectations from the previously evaluated limitations from the others. My expectations from the others are limited. So it is very difficult to reach balance between that. What do you expect and what they can offer? So I have managed to reach maximum balance of that. Not to expect more than that I can
and
get.
What are your actions or how you spend time? How you invest time?
And if this question is in this moment on this topic, then I can say that the time is not counting in this process. It lasts.
Okay, I'm not saying the effect, let's say you spend a day doing, as you were saying, I got all these priority things.
I don't know if I'm clear.
Okay, but nevertheless, this is, let's say, a shift goal. Can you say that in the last year you managed to achieve this goal by doing what? By better understanding people?
Yes, but how efficient am I? I think that I'm fully efficient if I reach this level.
So you think that you're fully efficient?
Yes.
By building some balance between the
expectations? Yes, reaching that balance between my personal expectations and the limitations.
What else?
I think it's very...
What else? This is for thing. What else? What else do you have on this? Nothing. This
one. Everything. Yes. Nothing.
Uh-huh. Interesting.
See, it's everything inside.
Okay.
Includes everything.
Let's.
Everything.
One more. We need one more. Tanya.
Teaching.
Okay, Vino, sorry. You will be next next to
us. I saved you from
Vino. Vino.
What I achieved in the last year is by teaching information systems, I started thinking in business terms.
So, can we call this professional development?
I think yes. Because I have started as a mathematician, and a programmer, and lately I have reached a new level, meaning went to the dark side.
Black box.
Yes.
May the force be with you.
Against me. Started teaching information systems, started research in language processing, and had some limited results. Revisited knowledge of discrete structures and mathematical statistics. Funny how I have improved myself.
Excuse me, what was that action?
The second thing? Mathematical statistics and discrete structures.
What did you actually do?
Revisited my knowledge.
Revisited is like going again to some place.
Revisited old books. Reviewed old knowledge.
Okay, what else?
Been on holiday by plane.
Been on holiday?
By plane. By airplane.
New experience.
New experience.
Holiday by plane.
And the most important is the first one, the business aspect. Changing the way of thinking.
Can we use this a little bit? So we have, to be honest, I'm very happy with this UACS paper. We have excellent. This is like, please take this. This is excellent case study without the persons involved, of course. So we have one individual who put 10 things. We have the second individual who put one thing only, and the third individual who put 3 things. So it is apparent for Kokan that we cannot choose between other things. So there was only one thing which for him is important. In terms of prioritization, he says, I achieved
maximum bounds between expectations and limitations. Between my expectations from the other's limitations.
Okay. So
not that
difficult. Okay, this was full prioritization of things. And then on the other hand side, we have Banner, who put like 10 things. Can I ask the class to vote on prioritization of what is, let's say, in terms of relevance and importance? Right, Professor, can you do this? So he said, how would you read, so from 1 to 10? Yes.
One interruption, but when we say how efficient I am, it
no
means
interruption, it is
you have goals. And whether you reach those goals with least resources, because that is what efficient means. Effective is to reach the goals efficient with least resources. So we cannot say which one is more efficient, but whether they reach their goals. Maybe Banek had 10 goals and he reached them, he is efficient. Maybe
Kogan
had only one goal and he reached that goal. So both are efficient.
But
you can have both in order to say whether you are efficient.
Some of these activities, everyday activities, is not goal.
For him, it was goal. For instance.
Just a second.
We're talking about reaching the goal as our ultimate prize. Now, let's get back to Lance Armstrong. He reached the goal, he won the Tour de France, but it actually wasn't his goal to take because he didn't reach it the right way.
That's what my character is.
But 7 years of goals have been erased. No one gets them because someone did not reach them the right way. That's called Lehman Brothers falling. Into
you're get some money in this Lehman Brothers story. You're raising the issue.
It's the Jewish lobby.
Okay, let's try to value to give some rating parenting. So how would you rate from 1 to 10 parenting?
I would rate it 1.
1.
Like one being the highest or the lowest?
1 being most important.
Okay,
10
is
okay. 10 is usually. Okay, let us do the following. So we have one, so it is not unexpandable pie. We have one pie, 100%, and Banek has 10 activities. So you cannot, the max, whatever you put, then you decrease the resources for the others. So parenting out of 100, how much do you give?
But Banek has to say that.
No, the class was.
But this is his priority list.
Okay, let's assume that we don't have mana and this is example. So the class votes mana. Pretend that you are not mana. Okay, parenting. How much?
50%.
50%.
50%.
Are we counting percent?
Yes.
30%.
Fractions. Another typical.
Parenting and coaching.
9/16.
Parenting and coaching.
30%.
And this comes from Anna.
Anna doesn't get
it. Have you, Nana? Come on.
Okay, from 0 to 100. Any suggestions? Anna.
Do we count when kids are together?
Counting is important for the time spent.
But we are
50. Anna suggests
50.
Do you
agree? Why don't we go 1 to 10 and then one is the.
Yeah, but then they will have to go like Eurovision both songs because you have to go to 12 and then it's too complicated.
But it's different for all of us.
I'm not sure.
Yeah.
For me, family is most important thing. For me, it's family. Pleasure, kids, family, that is the most important thing. If we had,
he didn't say wives.
It's natural.
Okay, how many votes 50%?
Okay, I said 0.
5 out of 30 is what?
10%.
Okay, the importance of personal or professional development.
The other.
The rest.
Okay. So we put like what? 30, 20, 50, 20?
Personal
development. Work. So it means like what? Career, bridge, being promoted, getting bigger salary, 20. Plus, how much would you put your work life? Person, what is the weight of work life?
But it's together with professional development.
Yeah, it's all together.
Yes. You develop professionally at work.
It's more like 40.
40.
You don't have 40. You already have.
You have 40. But at this 20, you don't.
Otherwise, we would be this.
On the personal, he had two things. He had my personal development and my professional development. So my personal development with other things, which are not professional development.
Yeah.
But it's private life and professional life,
yes,
to simplify the things. And then you might say 50-50,
yes,
60-40, you know. And private life is parenting, it's playing guitar, it's everything.
Yeah.
You know, I think that is the major decision that we make.
Family work balance. So he has professional development, review of knowledge, and personal experience,
private life.
So he puts three things.
But second one is also part of the first one, of the professional development.
Well, if you group everything, yes. But okay, then Nikita, then the question is, if you put everything on the professional, can you put everything on the professional side together? Like we as a professor.
No, we should prioritize. For instance, yes.
Papers.
That is what I did. Like research activities, projects, everything, teaching, three different things in professional.
You put,
yes.
Okay, what are your three things?
Research activities, projects, improved teaching, and managing.
And managing.
Yes.
So you already have four things.
Yes.
So you cannot actually.
No. I have to divide now my kind of work time over these activities, and then I have to prioritize.
Okay,
which is
last year.
Yes. Yes.
Where would you
yes.
put emphasis on these four things?
Yes.
Nick,
like
four
yeah.
things. Yes. So Nick has four things.
Yes.
That were teach,
research.
Project
and managing.
This is all about your work and you don't have anything about your life in general.
No, we are just talking about work. Yes, that is what I said. And then it is difficult for me personally to find a balance between these four things, not to mention even the family. So, you know.
Don't show this video to anyone else out of this classroom.
No, that is other 50% of my life.
So if I got you right, you divide the importance
yes.
of your life
working
activities
life or
50-50%. You say 50% I put my personal life, 50% on my work life.
Yeah. That is what I would like to achieve.
No, but the question was what did I do in the last 12 months?
What
I've been doing in the last 12 months.
Yeah.
Okay, so in this 50% which you assign to work,
these are
you
my
have four things, which are teach, research, projects, and managing.
Yeah.
So, do you divide this 50% equally to these 12, to these four things, or you put some emphasis somewhere?
I think a little bit less on teaching.
Like, can we go in?
If this is 100%, let's say. Okay, not 50, but 100%
okay,
professional life. I would say, probably 30 to project.
Speech, research,
honestly, research 25.
25.
Projects 30.
30.
30 managing or.
So
yes.
We are
and
now
at
60-85, so
15%
to teach.
Yes.
Okay, let's try to, let's use this as a good example. Everybody's got a similar problem as Nick. We all have several things to do, limited amount of resources, time, effort, we don't want to stay here 20 hours, we prefer to go play football, do other stuff, and we got budgets. And somewhere in the middle, we need to set priorities. Because we're never going to make everything well if we try to make everything. Unless you are building a Roman bridge, which is perfect, you cannot do everything perfectly. So you've got to do something that's got to give in terms of relative importance. Let me give you some suggestion that we give people. Because everybody's got the same problem, be it somebody running the canteen or the CEO. Relative terms, we all have got a to-do list, and we always go home. I have six things on my to-do list for today, as you were saying, I've done four, and you drive home and you're thinking about those two things you haven't done, and you know that the first thing we're gonna think about tomorrow morning, I need to finish those two things, which add up to the new thing. That approach is wrong, in my opinion. We have all the same approach. How can we improve on this? Well, first of all, if you manage to start sorting your shit priority-wise, the things you don't do become less and less relevant. If you manage to sort out your priorities in a correct way.
Prioritize.
Exactly. This is what advice we use in my business school all the time to talk about Pareto. As you can see, we divide the impact from the benefit from the, and we cross it with the effort. Which is exactly what we've done in the little exercise before. In order to reach a higher degree of satisfaction or perfection or aim, we should employ 400% more resources. A huge disproportionate amount. 80% more effort for 20% more additional result. Wrong. I mean, if you got time, and fine. If you want to do it, fine. But it's not so relevant. What is relevant is catching those two, three, four things which are priority. If you catch those well, the rest becomes less and less and less relevant. So let's go back to this and say, how do we decide this is priority and this is not?
question. Sometimes we have, I have a lot of situations where I can't do 80% or 70%. I have to do 100%. For example, the service. If I don't configure it 100%, it's not going to work. I can't stop at 70%.
I understand. In that case, because of your technical specification.
Yeah, most of my work is that. I can't do 80%.
A lot, probably.
Almost. Yeah, but it's not always about the work. You mentioned 10 things. One of the things was you are not professional, but other development. Which I assume, let's say, you learned to play guitar. So that's the question. Out of the 10 things, what is the priority? To have servers working, to educate your children, or to learn to play guitar?
Well, it's different stuff because work is professional part. Family, parents, children is personal stuff. So first,
Let me try to answer. I have this in mind. You cannot build the bridge which is 90% okay. It's got to be 100% okay. So certain tasks must be fulfilled well. But there are multiple tasks. As you said, Jacob, if we wrote down, as she was starting to do, exactly the things you do in a day, multiplied to 260 or maybe 150, I don't know how many days locally, right? You start to find that you do a number of things. Some of them have been perfectly fulfilled, others maybe less, etc. My topic is, how do you prioritize your stuff? Not how much do you do of each. That's your technical decision, and I will be nothing to say. So, how do we say, I've got 10 things to do. This one I'll do first, and this one I'll do later, which means that if I don't do it, I'm driving home instead of thinking, feeling defeated or incomplete or unsatisfied, I don't give a shit. As simple as that. How? Okay, let's identify the 1, 2, 3 things which matter. How do we do that? 3 steps in our experience. One, it's called problem definition. What are we trying to do? It's either my problem definition, my boss's problem definition, our common problem. What are we trying to do? What is my mission? What am I doing here? What is my budget? What is the target? What I'm doing in this semester might not be the same thing I'm doing in next semester. Or in this course might be a different thing from the other course. Whatever we're trying to do. How much time do we spend in doing this? Zero. This is the number one step in problem solving skills. Shooting at the right target. Most of our times, by our experience, we shoot the wrong target. We think we know exactly what we're doing, we think we know exactly where we should be going, and we don't have the faintest idea. Just because it's a complicated situation. The world is complex, there is a lot of interactions, and it's not clear. It's not clear. That's why communication is so important. There is never enough clarity. There is never enough transparency. Never. Never. We give stuff for granted. Think about this very simple thing. How many marriages fail? Now 50%.
Over. About 70.
Whatever. So we mean, and your companion is the person you know better in the world. The person with which you have the most intense and deep exchange of ideas and communication.
Hello to everybody. We were supposed to present a problem that was in front of us.
A problem?
We had a problem to make a presentation with 3 slides. So our problem was that, but the actual problem of which is the topic of the presentation is I cannot pronounce the
revitalizing
of the serendipity. So this is the actual problem. You have to revitalize the zoo. Obviously they had problems with the zoo, therefore in general they need money. So we have to, they were supposed to find ways to increase revenues, and they proposed 2 steps. The first step is to increase the agencies, and the second. We propose to increase the agency, and the second thing that we propose is to increase funds from other sources. At the moment, these are the most efficient ways that we consider to control the costs, because we believe that our costs are also very high. So the how do we plan to how do we plan to increase our gate receipts? It's through educational exhibits. So we are planning to make some educational exhibits for the kids and for everybody who comes here.
Just
make your own new animals. Listen, why don't you also help me with the presentation?
Okay, yeah. Well, then give a new excitement to what's already available in our zoo. So we would offer a watch and listen games for the kids. And then we would also step into further deepening the knowledge about animals. We offer a few more educational tools like teach and learn. That would also attract the kids to come more frequently, because this would be a long-term educational program for them and not a one-time visit to the zoo.
Yeah.
So the second thing, somebody wants to tell the second thing, or should I continue?
Okay.
No, sorry.
The second
thing. The
second
thing. It's because we can provide the experts with us. So the second thing that we plan to do is to increase visitors' appeal. We believe that the actual grounds of the zoo are not very well maintained at the moment, so we are planning to beautify our grounds, to make more, you know, to plant trees and flowers and so on and so on.
And we will do this. Okay, and the third thing related to increasing gate receipts is promotions. We're gonna start promotions locally and also with the local people and with the tourists.
These three things. This is this.
Yeah.
This is that.
No. Three things are the educational exhibits.
So these three things are here.
Yeah. Okay. The second test that we have, how to increase resources, is to increase funds from other sources. So what we were thinking, which sources can we, you know, count on? And the first thing is to have expanded membership. We want to have a drive, you know, an event where we will expand our memberships, and we expect to generate from there only $70,000. Yeah, we were thinking about also long-term membership, offering a long-term membership. We'll see how this will go, but we're expecting to generate $70,000. And then from the second thing that we are planning to do is campaign to stimulate donations. From this campaign, we are planning to generate much more money, therefore donors will explain how.
So, we have a CSR membership board, so we will use the companies that are renovating around the zoo. Stimulate more donations by offering to those companies to set the example on how can they contribute to the society.
So to finish up is, again, I want to leave you with these two steps that we're planning to do. The first one, increase the HSC, and then increase funds from other sources. But never forget that we are planning to control our costs. Thank you.
Okay, from the technical point, this presentation has very interesting things that we can discuss. So we want to discuss this, or we want to see others. Want to see others? Don't forget about it.
Okay.
What is that we liked about this, and what can be improved? There are a couple of very nice things, and something that can be improved. What do you think?
They supported each other without knowing that they should support each other.
Okay, and that's a good thing. Yes, that is a good thing. What else? Enthusiasm, that's fine, that's always a good thing. But on the technical side, what did you see that you liked and what can be improved?
The size of the first chart.
The size? Okay. Which is still an important thing. Anything that you can come up with that can be improved, or she's done something which I thought was quite interesting. What has she done at the end? At the very end, what has she done?
She concluded by showing the introduction.
She reinforced the conclusion, going back to exactly the first step, which was the first message. So, if you lost it or you are thinking about something else, as you go away, the last thing you take with you is her conclusion. That's always something we should do. Okay? Even if you don't know where it was planned. But it's the right thing to do. What can be improved? The second slide. The first slide as well, but the second more. I don't like this. Because it forces me to ask you what the hell you're trying to tell me. This is a session on business communication, okay? It's not about magic or about teaching, or about communication. We're talking about business communication, which is a very strict thing. And it's measured by the amount of action I will do later based on what I see. Measured is success. So the number one rule is make it understandable and simple for me to act on your problem solving. And not trying to do treasure hunt to understand what you mean, which is a major problem we have on this planet. We spend most of our time trying to understand what we really mean by that. And so our mind is not engaged on the problem solving and review, but on trying to understand what they're telling you. So we will see in a minute how you could make this more effective. It's fine, but it could be even more effective. Okay, another one we want to see? Who's next?
You would think that here, obviously, you don't have time.
Okay, so we focus on the two main activities we need to do. First is to increase the gain to 6. How? First, we need to upgrade the exhibits in the animal discovery centers. Okay?
Centers.
Can you please?
Natural capital.
Okay. Since we think that this is something that we miss up to now, and we want to increase the visual aspect to our zoo. Then the second thing is to beautify the grounds. As we know, we need to, as our town is growing and start becoming more and more beautiful, and mind the trees and flowers and everything, so we want to continue on this pace and input that in our zoo, and we want to be more beautiful for all our visitors. And the third one?
Ground promotion.
Okay.
Yes. For local residents and for tourists, with something that we are proposing, increasing group visit discounts, working on wide information campaigns, and what is most important in this case is to have active signaling. It is something that in the world is done. Active signalitic. Active signalitic, which means presence of billboards, tables, printed posters, every kind of information material, printed on the ground even, just to inform the community and to raise awareness about the necessity for doing this project. That all means active signalitic, which means giving signals, visual ones, to somebody that actions should be taken to.
Also to add, in order to attract the local inhabitants, we want to offer some group discounts to all the kindergartens, primary, secondary schools, even to the universities, in order more people to come and to see our zoo, and as well for the foreigners. At the first moment when they come, we'll give them brochures at the entry, for example, the airports or whatever means of transport they use, in order to be aware that we offer kind of tours, daily tours to our zoo, and they can use our, for example, transport, free of charge as well, to come to see our zoo.
This is a part of our testimony also, having printed material.
And the second area, to increase funds from other sources. This is also very important for us. Therefore, we concentrate to four categories, to launch, expand is the membership drive and donations stimulations. Basically on the individuals, so each individual we take separately into our focus, then the corporations, we can make kind of joint campaign with all our community in order to increase their awareness for the whole communities. They need to be responsible for the community and for the foundations in order for to make a better society and to have more invested in knowledge of the people, and especially the young children. We want the foundations to help us in developing our activity, and the government, the first intention to the government is to promote, of course, socialization of people and their activities, and we take into consideration that it is in the best interest of the government to have kind of this activity for all the people in the country, so therefore all these four groups will be in our focus to get money from in order to improve our foundation. And third point.
So, how to control costs and controlling costs, how to do it? By thinking globally and acting locally. Well-known sentence, but in context, it's hard to believe. But in context means that using something in other and different contexts. Think globally means that we have to think about the surrounding of the project, and to act locally means to concentrate on one single spot and to deal with it most efficiently as you can. Thank you.
Okay, very different presentation. This one, something I read, is one thing I really like, and others a little less. What do you guys think about this different approach?
I like very much. Can I say something? I like very much the how they were, you know, the approach they had with the pictures and with writing. But unfortunately, if you ask me, the handwriting is not understandable. So if you present it, I don't know. Depending, I guess it depends on which public it's going to
be. Maybe if it was a serious thing, they would make it understand.
Anyhow, I like the highlighting, all the things that they did.
I feel like the zoo is a method, and this is a warmly defined approach.
Yes. Other comments? What we like, what we don't like.
Very well done. Original.
Don't be fascinated by the graphics.
No, that's what really gets a lot of people.
But it's only the small part of the thing.
You don't need, because most people are visual.
Yes.
Most people are visual. They like the idea of what is happening in the presentation. It perceives their emotion and their thoughts. Okay, maybe he thought about something. Let's see what he's doing.
Can I
do something? First, when Kukan starts writing, I didn't like it the first thing. It's first time I do PowerPoint writing. But actually, when he starts,
it's a beautiful idea. I'm not.
It's like a personal thing. Like you make an own kind of all the time marks on something, and it's kind of personal thing. This is not. I'm saying that it's boring to look at official done kind of PowerPoint presentation, but kind of this make it personal, and it's interesting for all the time to be present. And I don't know. For example, I would ask what was the maybe percentage of big participant when we were talking before from the other presentation. How much concentrated were the people? That's my question. For example, instead of the first one. Did we get the attention more or no?
The slides got my attention, to be honest.
You want to check?
No, I'm just asking.
Yeah, if you want to
check. I keep looking at the koala.
Yeah.
Yes.
My daily advice is, stuff is visually attractive all the better, as long as it's reasonably simple, and that's because we're talking about money, as usual, we're talking about effectiveness, managerial decisions. So I'm not sure whether somebody who sees a presentation, for example, you're asking him for funding, or you're presenting something like a project. I don't want to see you spending a lot of time on graphics instead of on the roof. This is a very good affair communication. So this is excellent from all points of view. There's one thing I really like, and something that I think can be improved, which is not the end right, that's perfect. So I'll do it, it's fine.
Yeah.
I really like the pyramid structure, which is this. This makes me understand exactly where we are, what we want, and where we are. So, we say we are in topic one, getting seeds, which has three subtopics, which is those three goals. And each of them have got sub issues. So, a major, a minor, and additional sub minors.
Can I ask something?
Huh?
Can I ask something?
Here.
Can I ask something? Sure. We were afraid that we would have a lot of space. That's why, let's say, we were just with the three basic actions to be done.
Yeah.
Under the first heading.
What I'm saying is the structure. As little as little text as possible, always. No text is perfect. You just put pictures, you know, if you're talking money, you need to have numbers. You put some numbers, and then with a start. Here is no numbers. If you hope to win a contract or a buy-in for emotion, I don't think you're going to go very far. You need to convince people it's worthwhile doing. Okay, so but I particularly like this structure, because this is the way things should be done in the managerial communication world, a structure. So this is like a pyramid turned left. See, then I put a pyramid there. That's exactly what we should be doing here. Okay? This is just a horizontal pyramid, which is fine. And the other thing that, and this is excellent, what I could improve is, this is what, and this is how. So if you just hear right actions, it's very powerful. Action, what we're going to do. This is what we're going to do, and this is how. Wow. Don't give me the problem. Give me the solution. Give me what you're trying to do. Give me the ideas. Give me how you want to get there. I want that. Give me the solutions. Just put actions there. Get done. I'm not sure about the thinking globally, peace in the world, and stuff like that. I'm not sure about economics. I'm sworn enemy number one of anything which is generic. If it's generic, it doesn't belong in anywhere. If in this case we do this and this like that, fine. If we should, we could, we might. Let's hope that it doesn't cut any ice. But a pyramid.
Bravo.
На Олавино, в Абишуа, на Брега, там Хемай Котче, да.
Не кажи ли?
Хемпарът е...
Сте го изчуристи?
Да.
Е, твоето работа. I should pay for this, because having professors are like students. We should pay for this. Having professors acting like students.
10 million a year.
Maybe
engaging volunteers, people who would like to save animals. Next, money-wise, using internal resources money-wise, it was like how to earn more money, how to create more beneficial environment, like for every 2 tickets, 30 is free, there are parents and children. So technically, one parent with 2 children can visit the zoo cheaper. Then for children below 10 or 12 or whatever, free access. Then for families with 3 or more children, groups of with 3 or more children, guided tour. So there is an expert who will be, let's say, on call from 10 to 14, from 10 to 1500, never mind, who can guide them through the zoo, and of course offering scholarships. This was done previously, this isn't, I'm afraid, too original, but nevertheless, to buy attractive animals as probably an animal is a symbol of that company. So that in a sense, and provide their support, because you see some of the animals can be very expensive in their upkeep, like, I don't know, lions, maybe they eat 5 to 10 kilograms meat per day, I don't know, I improvise it.
Or but one man for 2 days.
That's it. And of course, we had this much time, so that is all we have to do to get to the
doctor.
How do you know?
That's me.
Anna is a female. This is not
gender. In the break, in the fit. But the summer she is me the right here.
Anyway, comments on this?
It's interesting to observe how different patterns we all have when presented a problem and how to come to a solution. Of course, so that's good, we all different. But in this particular case, if I didn't know what the problem was all about, I would never understand why they're doing everything seriously.
You don't read enough.
So you're saying that the problem is not highlighted, the question hanging
out? Not even stated. I can't find it. I mean, we know because we have the same access, but it's not even outlined, not even with one word. And the actions are not stated in what direction they're going to.
That's a fair comment. Other comments? What we like or we don't like? Comments. What we like, what we don't like.
Personally, I like the development of the ideas.
The ideas are being there.
The details about possibilities it was well presented.
Yes. That is true. Something we didn't like? A lot of text, yes, that's true. They went another way. They decided to do a different thing, respect to what was in the text. That's what they said, and that's what they did. And I don't know whether they said it or not, but they decided to do this. So my only comment on this is that it's a risky path if you want to interpret what's going on. Sometimes you can be very successful because then you anticipate stages. Sometimes you can again. Is what I said before, you've got to keep into consideration into your equation of the solution, the criteria of success of your judge. There is a judge, you are presenting an idea to somebody, you want him to buy it, you want him to sponsor it, you want him to convince him. So you've got to answer his question. There is a question hidden in every problem, right? And which is what I think he was saying. The only thing that I think should be improved here is what I told the governing thought. Okay, what is your conclusion? What do you think you can do? Can you do it? Yes, no. What do you suggest? I see the sub actions, and
but it's the, there's something missing in terms of punch. Okay, we can do this this way. That's my perception.
Our approach was simply to state some measures how to improve the situations. And I think that this wasn't meant to be a presentation in front of wealthy sponsors or somebody, simply to state measures and to create kind of consent, kind of atmosphere, what to do next.
Yes.
So this is, this should be treated, or it, at least it was our approach, simply to give these measures as a kind of suggestions,
yes,
proposal to the manager.
And
simply the person who can say, okay, I like it, okay, I don't like it, okay, what do you mean by this?
No, we all like it, we all like it. We want to pay attention to the fact that feedback doesn't have to be right. Feedback is feedback. Means it's my perception of what you think. Doesn't have to be right. It's just my perception of what you said or done. Now, you can take it into consideration or not, depending. If you're talking to the guy who runs the canteen about the budget of the school, maybe it's not relevant. But if you're talking to somebody, maybe the general manager, it could be interesting. Whatever he gets on this side, we should be worried not with what we mean, but what gets received on the other side. Because that drives the success or not of what you're doing.
From a formal point of view, I didn't want to disturb the relationship, but it's sometimes it's important if somebody tells you three slides, it's three slides. Somebody, for example, if you were, let's say you give us the assignment, if you were the chief, you can be offended of, let's say, moving to fourth, for example. And also to the, not pointing to the main topics of what are the issues. Because it's a risk that somebody can take it as a root action, not that you have all the best intentions sometimes, but not following the rules. That's my experience from real life. Just by improvising something that on your own doesn't mean if it is in the best way or it is with the best manners and maybe it makes sense and everything. Sometimes if the boss tells you some formal things, you must sometimes dissipate them first and then it's just a comment on
okay,
formal point of view.
One question from me to you all. Was it plain and simple?
No.
No. Okay. So. Next one.
Two million.
Volume of sales. And this is how we decide
to do it. I will present first what are our suggestions of how to improve the sales and the revenues. And on the other hand, I will suggest other measures that we propose in order to get money from outside. First of all, the first thing we need to do is to upgrade the exhibits. We decided to pick different target groups. After a research that we did, we decided that we need to actually diversify the target groups. We need to have three different types of exhibits that will attract three different types of customers. One will be the animal discovery centers, which will be the cheapest one and it won't be offered to children. The other one will be the natural habitats, which is actually more interesting and it incorporates more elements. And the third one would be the exotic animals, which anybody can visit, but of course it's going to be more expensive. The second thing we need to do is to upgrade our grounds. So we have to revitalize them, we have to make them more appealing to the visitors and to everybody who wants to come to the zoo. And the third thing we need to do is to run promotions in order to attract visitors, meaning we have to attract them with visual aids. Hopefully CSR will be addressed in this manner. How we plan on doing it? We need to generate two types of revenue streams. One should be patrons. We intend on addressing patrons that will donate $70,000 into our zoo that we can use for the measures we previously met or said. And we will have another campaign that will stimulate additional donations from individuals, people that are interested, people that are in some way affected by the community.
This is all tax exempt.
The second category should yield $280,000. So the total amount
that's a very strong point you mentioned, right?
Yes, sure it is. I mean, it's a natural history thing. They have to be tax exempt. People like to give money so they don't have to give to the government.
The answer is yes. So that's a very strong point you have. If you have a very strong cup, why don't you pay?
Well, we don't usually put down papers like that. It's just you give it out, so it's not a.
Why don't you put it there? Tax free or tax deductible. It's a strong card, right?
But you're bound by one piece of paper. But if you say it, it'll be a little different.
Okay.
And we believe that extended memberships would also generate an additional revenue. And all these programs are actually in our budget for this year. But as of next year, we need the additional funding in order to get the tickets that we need, the funding that we need. So thank you for your attention.
Ali znoju na narod, da mi to pule
Добро, и кой нагласа ви беше обишена, да вчера беше свири с това тази
дори... Ама не беше обишена нагласа, 42 спрема 47
прима.
Да, как беше 0-3 беше. Много тайна. Ай, вие се лавя с тази 6-1-1.
What we need to do in order to meet that crisis is increase the revenues. By increasing revenues, we need to increase our fees receipts and increase funds from other sources. As we've known so far, the past 8 years, our gate revenues have been decreasing. That is why we propose that we need to increase them by increasing the perceived value of the zoo. How? By increasing the educational value. We need to invite National Geographic or another global corporation to film documentaries from our zoo in order to attract more visitors. Increase the visitor appeal. By this, we mean to better our habitats for our animals, bring new exotic animals, and run promotions in order for more people to know about our cause, what we do, and how our zoo functions. The next thing we put on our slides was how to increase funds from other sources. This means fundraising. By fundraising, we need to launch a membership drive, which will increase our revenues by $70,000, and stimulate donations by getting rich patrons to name animals and donate a piece of animal for themselves. Basically, this is our brief concept, which my team and I devised. And I hope that by the end of this meeting and the cocktail, we will be able to help us with some more ideas in order to save and revitalize our zoo. Thank you very much.
Any comments on this?
Perfect.
Very short, to the point. Less articulated than yours, for example. The only thing I don't like is launch membership drive slash what?
Go slash and get their money.
One thing I really like about this, that's a personal inclination, is there is verbs in the present or future time. More peace in the world. Less violence in football stadium. Bullshit. No. How we think we're gonna do it. That's my personal intention. How this is gonna happen. Why this is going down. Why this is happening. What we wanna do. Anything. As long as this subject, well, maybe it's Latin, but Latin grammar origin. So, soggetto, verbo, complemento, oggetto.
What?
Subject, verb, object, full stop.
Simple sentence.
Simple, but you know who is doing what. Who wants to do what. Okay, so, excellent job everyone, Mr. Professor. So we are obviously very, all very good at doing these things. And, but we can only improve. That's why we're here. So let's see what we can improve. Can we go back to the original slides? There is two or three slides I want to show you. If I find. Yes. I was not this one. The communication. Effective communication. I like this. This is basically our students when we teach. And or other professors, when other professors are teaching. That's us. Okay? A couple of tips about this kind of activity presentation. Extremely important. One is the following. Catches up on our discussion. Imagine in a presentation to be effective, must be effective 5 years from today, taken from a drawer.
when you don't know why it was held, you have no idea what's going on, you pick it up, there is no explanation, nobody there to tell you, you call, you read those lines, and you know what the hell it means. So if it's not there, because you haven't put it there, you're not never gonna play that card. That just to say, so we'll talk about it personally. Fine, it should be somewhere. A good presentation is a presentation that you can do later without assistance of anybody explaining and understanding. That's why it should be simple. It should be understandable, simple, sharp, summary to the point, synthetic. The more synthetic, the better. The clearer the message, the better. So there is a structure to do this. There is a structure. Business communication is not normal communication. It's another thing. The thing that works backwards. The logic of business communication is completely the opposite of normal communication. We think in a sequential way. If A, then B, then C, conclusion is Z. Major mistake we all do, is I want to explain to you something. So I'll give an introduction, background, facts, ideas, stuff, and then at the end there is a conclusion. This is totally, completely wrong in business communication. Business communication works the opposite way. Imagine you read a crime story by Agatha Christie that starts, there is a dead man on the floor, and the butler is the killer. And then you have 300 pages of crime story explaining that. That's exactly how business communication must work. Otherwise, very simply, it doesn't work. Communication is measured by the activity that happens afterwards, by the amount of success you have in passing your message. That's why, like it or not like it, the message from that movie was clear.
You are fired.
Now do I have your attention? Absolutely, yes. Now you got my attention. You can bet your ass that people will act if they want to act. So business communication is not the same thing as the other stuff. Has to be done with its rules, and the rule is hit me with the message immediately. Forget the intro, forget everything, introduction, forecast, everything. Okay, we are here to discuss the problem of our Zoom. We can save the Zoom by doing two things. That's the message. Or, we have no idea how to do this. Or, maybe we can do it. I don't know. There is a structure here. The first thing is what we call the governing thought. The governing thought is the message. The governing thought is the answer to the question. When you're tackling anything, there is a question. Why are we here? What do we do in the zoo? Whatever it is. How do I do this? Question. In somebody's head. Myself, my jury, nobody my jury. So I need to do what I said before, include the jury's criteria of success into my equation, and then give him the answer he needs, using my brain, my independence, my quality, but I want to give him his answer, the answer he needs, which might be nice or not nice, but it's the professional answer to the question. So the first thing you do in business communication, message. This is what's gonna happen. This is what we're gonna do, and then after this, I'll explain you why. I don't start with background and facts, explanation, bullshit, forget this. Message. We are here to discuss how to save this zoo. Fine. We found out that it's possible to save it doing two things. Now let me explain you what. And at the end, and so governing thought immediately. You have a problem. The scheme is the following. Situation, complication, question, answer. Situation, complication, what's hurting? Revenues are going down for the last 8 years. Question, what the hell are we gonna do with this thing? We keep it, we sell it, what do we do? Answer. This is done in the first 30 seconds. 1 minute, I mean, we use our judgment in terms of education and culture and diplomacy and everything, but at the end of the day, the message comes immediately and is an answer to a question. Gathering thought. Then you build a body which is a pyramid, a logic tree. You know, it's a logic tree. And those are what somebody has done in their presentation with indentment. Okay, you can do it this like, you can do it visually like this. This is a text. You can do it as a text like this. You see, this is what somebody has done. This item here is a lot less important than this. So I'm not going to even read this. No, no. I want to stay with the governing thought which is there. We recommend a two-part program, etc., etc. We recommend it. We have an answer. Okay? And then there is two majors. And then there are some minors. This is a pyramid. Or you can build it this way. A logic tree. This thing here, you don't even want to talk about it if you are not happy with that. Maybe you don't even need. You need to talk about this if my counterparty asks, what about this? Fine, I developed this part. But it's so minor in respect to that I'm not spending any time talking about this at all, unless you want to know. We are making the same mistake because we are Aristotelian and we like completeness. It's like priorities, it's the same thing. We don't have to do everything. Concentrate on what matters and forget the rest, unless you want to know, and then I'm ready. Professionally, no problem. But who cares about that? If the upper part doesn't work, the rest doesn't matter. If it works, the rest will follow. Okay? You must build the pyramid. So, the structure of the presentation is done. Where is it? Where? I put it somewhere. Here. First strategy is what we want to achieve. So somebody is done in an alternative way, which for me is fine. Because it means you've been asking yourself the question, what do we need to do? That requires a lot, I call it problem definition, requires a lot of attention. Why are we shooting there and not there? As you see that there was a sign there with the arrows, that's what I mean by that. Where are we shooting? First objectives. Determine the governing thought. What's the answer? Because suppose you are presenting to your boss and he's busy, or he's got to leave, or somebody or his wife calls in, or you, I don't know, give him the message and forget the rest. We'll talk about the rest later, but at least he's got to know your point of view, your message. That's why you've been working. You've been investing your time and effort, give him the bloody answer. And then we'll explain it. Not the opposite. The sequential principle doesn't work in business communication. I don't have time to listen to you for an hour. We all make the same, with the exception of the last presentation, which was incredibly brief, but said the same things. So I would rate it very effectively, because it doesn't, I don't have to follow you for 10 minutes for getting the same info. Synthesis is a virtue. It's a huge, monumental quality that we don't normally have. Because we want to show you, major mistake we make, all of us, we want to show you we made a lot of work, big effort, all long nights. I don't care. I'm on this side watching you, getting your message. I don't care if you're working 24 hours or 10 minutes. Give me quality answers. Right? You're paid. Give me quality answers. Doesn't matter if you're 24 hours of work or not. Give me the answer, then we'll talk about the rest. That's business communication in the normal world. Okay? So, first strategy. Second, structure. This is what I was saying about the start. Situation, complication, question, governing thought, answer. Bank, the pyramid, which is the logic tree. You can do it this way. I like it this way because it's visual. Building blocks. But you can do it text as it was done before. Fine. Finally, conclusion. What is conclusion? What's you have done? Basically, I'm telling you the same thing I said at the beginning, again, in a slightly different way. Now you have the elements to understand why we said it. So I say something, then I explain it, and then I reinforce my conclusions, that now you're in a better position to understand. This is classic McKinsey. McKinsey does do this all the time. They say, when they're trying to generate buy-in, approval for what they do. They are the best in the world at doing this. They say, tell them what you're going to tell them. Tell them what you told them. Fantastic. Maybe excessive, I don't think so. There is certainly, you can bet that you go away from that meeting that you have the message, and not some confused perception. Very, very, very effective. Very effective. This is the way it should be done. In conclusion, I wrote here, somebody did it, next steps. What happens next? That's another important point. After conclusion, a hook into you for the future. I want you to sign a contract, I want you to keep listening to me, I want you to find me a job, I want another interview, a hook, next steps, a door open, keep the door open, don't shut the door, we let you know, thank you, that's a bad conclusion. The next step is, let's find a common way to end up this stuff, so that there is an open door for the future. We don't want to close any doors, all doors must be open. We don't want to make any enemies. We don't want to be left hanging, waiting for a phone call, if possible. Sometimes it's not possible. Gathering thought. You see the pyramid? At this level, everything is coherent. But this stuff is logically more important than this. And this is the gathering thought. That's the way business communication works. So, main message, one. Immediately. Up front. And my suggestion, verbs, not increasing sales. We can increase sales. Much different story. Completely different perception. I understand exactly what you mean, and I know what you think. Because increasing sales, can we increase these sales? Is it possible? Do you think? Do you hope? Did you think about it? What are you asking me to do? So one is main message up front. And what I prefer, action titles. An action title is the title of a slide which doesn't need a slide. You know exactly what I mean. Secondly, synthesis. No text, no explanations, facts and numbers, or just very short things. We will do that. It's possible to do this. We make as much money. It's easy to do this than that. And structure. What we normally teach our more junior people is to support themselves with facts when they're presenting, especially business proposals, because they don't have the credibility of a professor or the credibility of a businessman, is leave as little as possible to appeal and as much as possible to facts, which means show them at least two metrics. One qualitative, one quantitative. So EBITDA, cash flow, profit, sales, revenues, cost, something, one, quantitative. And the other, it's like a matrix. And on the other side of the axis of the matrix, qualitative. Normally time, riskiness, implementation, easy, difficult, green light, red light, stuff like this. So that you show your audience that you've been thinking through how much this stuff is worth and how doable it is. You've been doing that before showing advanced analysis that makes sense. Okay, this is the way we suggest to do presentations, because this way they're effective. Problem, answer, question, answer. Structure of why, the logic structure that supports that idea, conclusion, next steps, and synthesis. Zero text. What do you think, boss?
I think you will just...
This is an exercise, or one of the many little tricks we play with students. Like, we give them this, and we say, can you do it better? This is the same thing. Dry up, like dry tomatoes. Take all the water.
The KISS principle, keep it short and simple.
KISS.
KISS.
He knows, KISS. We love KISS.
What is Kiss,
yeah, but
Professor?
The font of the letters can be also a little bit bigger.
Stupid, we say.
Don't say stupid, keep it short and simple.
It's on this side.
Victoria, but we cannot read from here.
Huh?
We cannot read from here.
Doctor is only the doctor.
No, Anna is without the doctor.
Keep it simple and as stupid as
possible. As small as possible, size font.
Okay, so what unfortunately I tell students when I have a chapter on communication, and to be honest, this is why I usually try to skip it, is that at USCS, unfortunately, we are terrible. We are a disaster in communication. So instead of actually lecturing, I just give you examples and say, please, do not follow these things in your life.
We are the leaders of miscommunication.
We are absolute leaders of miscommunication.
No.
Okay, we'll see.
You should compare, but it should be the relative terms.
Let me start with a few things. First of all, so theory recognizes written, verbal, electronic communication. Of course, we can spend few sessions like this in much nicer scenery, maybe somewhere in open to discuss all options, but I'll just give you some clues and maybe we can discuss how to resolve them. What Victoria now said just reminded me of one thing, and that was happening a year and a half, and we were in Vienna, me, Nikitsa, and Emil on the ACDSB conference. That was not quite sure, but probably he was working, Emil Berisha was still working in the office, so he was about to leave, and Venera sends me email. So now we are talking about combination of verbal and electronic communication. And the email goes like that. I remember we were going on that lunch, if you remember, at the Belvedere place, coming back, and I am reading the email on the BlackBerry, and I reply, okay, to Venera, and Venera says, okay, what's the first or the second thing? Of course, I didn't completely see that there's a second thing. And it is just one of the examples which probably happened here and there. I also did the same. Was with Victoria, but then there was an explanation. I was in Kansas. He sent me a repeatable email about the things, and I said, I'm sorry, I'm in Kansas. And then the reply is, what the hell are you doing there? Are you taking a rodeo drive? let's see practical things where we make mistakes. But why is this related to leadership? Why is this related to leadership? Well, the theory suggests that leaders will spend, I don't know, more than half of their time in dealing with conflicts. The problem is that most of the conflicts come for miscommunication, or for misperception, or for different points on the same things. My simple message is, to be honest, I like this idea of Victoria. Start with the end. That's the first message, and then understand. My first message, or the last if you want, is start from the standing point that whatever I want to tell you, I think A, and the guy or the girl to whom I'm talking thinks B. Most likely if there's a third person involved, he or she will think C. So in order to get effective communication, which means, I think it will be somewhere slide. What's the purpose of communication? To get things done. So how do we measure whether the communication is effective? The slide is nice, or two lines instead of three? No. If the job is done properly.
What happens next?
What happens next? Very simple. There is no other KPI. There is no other measurement role. This is real life situation. Unfortunately, 4 years ago, so the situation goes like this. I am at home preparing for the class. Of course, the names are kind of mixed,
change, but basically we are talking about the persons who are present here. And of course, we'll try to avoid the names, but more or less we will see what is happening in the US here. So this is 12 noon. So I'm working at home preparing for the class, and I understand that there is something missing. And I said mail. Sorry, Victoria, for not understanding, but I will try to understand. So, OB book, Robin's page, 5:10 to 5:30. To be honest, I'm also not very good in communication. In fact, opposite, quite bad in communication. This is why I try, and please, whenever you feel that I'm not direct or correct enough, please let me know, because apparently I do send 20 emails per night, not per day. So sometimes, unfortunately, what I mean is not always understood from the other side. So feel free, I won't feel offended, I won't feel nervous. I'd be much happier if you ask me now, please, what did you mean by this? Then if you have open open space, you wonder all around. Here I was quite, let's say, precise. From page 5:10 to 5:30, there are two cases. Dressing for success and politics of base timing. Would you consider to scan this and, if possible, give me, send me send me two separate PDF files, ideally, Word. Okay. So now we are talking 2.5 hours later. B will send you the cases. I said, excellent, thank you. Now B sends the case. Look at the case. Is there a problem?
Yes.
What is the problem? Well, it's not half of the case, but it's only one question. For
questions
to know.
Are missing.
This case actually has four questions. So this was sent, yes, to Ensemble. So quite a frequent class. So now I'm still working at home. My starting point class will start at 6 p.m. And I see 5 o'clock, I see now the cases, and now I go to completely mad with my famous sentence, when a refrigerator is not a refrigerator. So guys, I say it is done, but it's not done. Attention to detail and precision, and very simple message. Now I see. Basically, I write to those guys who are involved in this story that on the first case there is only one question, in the book there are four. On the second case there are two questions, in the book there are four. I don't think it's fair because people pay 4,600 euros to be in this class. So that same class, 30 students, paid $120,000. Divide by number of classes and we will see what's the value of that one afternoon where we are playing something completely stupid. Whoever was involved was not playing with himself, with herself, with myself. Basically, we are playing with our customers. We paid seriously, we will come here out of charity or because we like it. Plain and simple. One case. And in good case scenario, this would have been a historical case and we don't have anything new. But we come to the, we enter the time machine, fast forward, and we go to this shooting video, which was not a disaster, but it was a complicated case. Just take a look how long did it take to actually do this. What I'm trying to suggest with the following cases, to follow Vittorio's guidelines, even if without creating a serious conflict, if you do not communicate properly, you will end up in losing time, energy, efforts, even if there is no major conflict. So what happened here is that there was not actually a big conflict, but I made a mistake by not communicating clearly, by not using the most rich channel of communication. So how did it start? So I said,
control, control with growth.
Control with growth.
So, but now we have a different situation. That's why I was doing this with institutional leadership. The situation is that Nikola Zulewski, who would normally do these things, is currently not here because he got a scholarship to go 2 months in Australia to improve his English language. So I sent email to Eddie, who is now covering and doing stuff in Nikola, saying, look, I'm saying, so this is how I start. So it is 25th of October.
What?
This is the time. So this is like what, 10 days, something more ago. Guys, we have a professor from UK teaching. There was this Bob White. And can you organize filming for him? This is number one. And how does this thing develop? Filter. It says, of course I would like to do that, but also I would like to take Vidurian classes, but should we ask students if they agree? Because somewhere in the meantime I came up with the idea to take these classes, and then we were discussing, we've been discussing this, I believe, with Iko, our director in this. Director who is not currently here, how to organize, how to establish this room as a room which potentially can be always taken. Then it goes like, for the UK professor, we only need him, nothing else. For Vittorio, yes. Can you ask Ileana and Nico Carr? Now I'm holding in Ileana, which completely doesn't have a clue what have been discussed previously. That we set 4 cameras, my idea was to put 4 cameras in 4 angles. And that we set 3-4 mics, my idea was to instead of these 3 mics in which are now to put 3-4 mics somewhere around. We can buy or rent all of this stuff. Not all those things develop. Says, okay, I saw Ralph yesterday. Now Ileana sends a message. But we talked about all of this, he is providing me a... So once again, Ileana talks about getting permission from the students. And they're completely right about this. If we film tomorrow students in the real class, we should probably put it in the contract. Yes, please note somewhere that if we decide to do this, students will have to, when they enter university, then they will have to agree that... sign a waiver that they can be used in materials that the university, stuff like that. But now we're talking, so 3-4 males already have in the streets. Now Ivo sends a mail. And to be honest, that was in fact a very good point, because Ivo sends a mail where he actually more or less tries to confirm his statement of what do we understand about the situation. So then I send email to Ivo with lots of details, and the good thing which happened is that this is why we have this taping today, is that somehow I met Eddie early in the morning on the stairs, and then we talked for like 2.5 hours. With all possible details. And then we send this email with all possible details to Ivo. What I'm trying to suggest is, this is a good example. After many, many emails, we are already lost. So can you imagine 4 serious or semi-serious persons? It was me, it was Ileana involved, it was Ivo, it was Eddie. We spent like at least 2 meals per day to come to solution where no one understood what are we talking about. Do we talk about YouTube, Bob, this, Vittorio with students, Vittorio without students, so 20 different understandings.
You have
to master what has to make. You have to master what in the real you're really right. So you have to master whether or not we film you. And then he said, yes, I want to be filmed, but without media on the questioning sessions. So yes, it was happening in the meantime.
So complete confusion out of the board. We solved it properly by having open communication channels. So communication channels vary by richness. The simplest channel is I send you email. It has advantages because you have the record afterwards. I call you, then it's personal. I talk to you in person, you have even more layers added. But even here, once again, I made a serious mistake. Which was, I started parallel talks with the filming guys about the filming part, and I asked Venera to organize this event with Vittorio. So what happened was that I didn't manage to be smart enough to tell Venera that I'm talking to the film guys. So today, it was happening this morning. Venera thought that
we'll be having 11:30.
Venera thought that we'll be having this training in the amphitheater, and the filming guys were preparing the filming equipment here. So, once again, maybe my worst element of my personal leading style techniques, Noemo, is communication, but apparently it happens very often at USCS. If you remember, Buddy, and I told you to save that part for the second class, when you were saying something like... Yes, how should I know that you wouldn't... how should you know that by what measurements you will measure your life?
What exactly is required?
What exactly is required? Well, as much as we say in the classroom, it's good that there are not right and wrong answers. Unfortunately, in the real life situation, we must try to understand to put ourselves in other people's shoes. Unfortunately, we cannot prescribe everything. You have probably noticed that now I'm talking personally. I am now trying to be very specific. Look, you made a mistake here and you get 10% down, or you're excellent here and you get 500 tenors down. Which is, once again, not the thing I like. But unfortunately, and apparently, it seems that sometimes we need to use this rule of making things not the best. So, what is the message after these few slides? Try to communicate as much open as possible. Number two, if you are not sure about it, ask. The sooner one asks, the lesser the problem becomes. I mean, I just put two things on the slide, but we can probably talk about this for like 3 days about different issues in USCS. Few points what Victoria mentioned I would like to reinforce. Know who is the judge, and try to empathy with the recipient of the message. What's the meaning of having excellent project done if other people involved in the project, relevant people, are not happy or are not informed? What's the relevance of having excellent project done if the project is not done on time? So I maybe wouldn't go into many other details, but I will try to stick with these things, and always, please always, start from the proposition that what I communicate, what I want to send as a message, because the communication is sender, recipient, message and channel of communication. Channel can be here, so communicate directly, phone, email in most of the cases. What I mean by sending, by putting a few words in the line, is not the same what the other person thinks. When I try to put the message, can I try to understand what the other person will think when he or she receives the message? Well, I'm not saying
saying it's easy task, to be honest, it's very heavy task to be done. And to be honest, we don't have always time to do this. But the practice actually shows us that it's better to invest much more time in communication upfront than face all downsides and mistakes that will follow up eventually. Yesterday we had a small communication case, we can discuss this with Magda, but as a good case where misunderstanding was resolved in the very first 10-15 minutes. So what is happening? Magda calls me or wants to see me. I'm very nervous because I'm always nervous before classes. And she comes and says, okay, I need you to sign this application. And I said, what's the application? Well, she says, 50% discount for I don't know, some relative, let's say, of a professor who is not here. I said, well, I was really talking to the professor, but we really didn't mention 50%. I know that, usually friend of a friend comes to you and says, yes, he or she will try to get some discount, but 50%, it was kind of, I'm not sure, I'm trying to call the professor. So now I already spent 15-20 minutes. Try to call the professor. Professor's in he's having no exam. So he said, I will come back in 15-20 minutes. He, after half an hour, comes. I said, look, this thing I really promised something, but I'm not sure that I promised 50%. I was kind of feeling not very comfortable in that situation. He says, no, but Marian, it says, you promised 10%, 50% now, and the rest on the installments. Okay, so I'm happy, the professor is happy, I called Magda, and we spend some time, we spend resources. Time is most valuable resource, time is not a renewable resource, but we resolved it right now. If we didn't resolve it, it would have gone to finals. Eventually I would be mad at the professor, or he would be at me, or Magda would thought I'm crazy, or someone would hear the idea. But, yes?
Is it time for a good example, just this
yes.
One? On Friday of last week...
But just you, because otherwise we'll stay here until Sunday with all the examples.
The final class of the students before the midterm exam week, they asked, if possible, to reschedule the exam from 9 a.m. to the afternoon, because they have an evening late afternoon, almost evening exam the previous day. And I said, not a problem with me, let me check during the break about this. And it's best if I can give you the answer while we are here. This is Friday, last day before the working week. So, during the break, I talked with the person with the records office, not present, I'm sorry. And I explain the situation, and I explain, emphasize the fact that it's important to check and get information while I'm in class because the student will hear it right away. And we agreed. I thought it's clear. The class is almost 5 to 4, almost ready to finish, no news. And I think, okay, students are waiting, coming patient, when are we going to have the exam? You can imagine how much. And I said, okay guys, no news, I'm sure it means they don't have a decision yet. You'll be informed as soon as possible on Monday. Later that afternoon, when I was able to check email, I see the email sent. Yes, your request is approved. You can have, the students can have. So perfect information, everything that we needed, but sent via email. Okay, so as far as the person was concerned, the person completed the task in a perfect way, checked everything, conveyed the message, but did I get the message? Did the student get the message?
Okay. One of the good things we can mention here is that though our good friend Vittorio, of course, from the positive point of view, criticizes us when we are not doing well,
one of the things where he was actually praising us was that the students asked him yesterday to have a vision of us. So congratulations, both of you. The downside of that their additional classes is that we'll have to finish in a few minutes because the students will crash in and they'll be completely confused by seeing us as students. But what's the upside and what we can work out of this? This is my personal request, and please, whatever is not clear, let us clear it up. So, you have probably seen the action plan I've written and sent after the two strategic planning sessions we have had and after the joint session of business, political science and faculty of law. Well, Vittoria was kind enough to give me proper feedback on this. The most important thing in proper communication is feedback based on facts, not on individual. That's the difference between an opinion and a feedback. And the feedback was, wow, who will go with this plan? You have like 6 pages of different points, bullets, numbers, and no one will actually read this, not never to finish it. I was feeling sorry for myself for the first 15 minutes. I said, wow, but I worked 3 days on this. But actually, he's completely right. But one of the things that I'm doing is that action plan is to improve actual communication things at USCS is to start council meetings. So, now I'm directly addressing our HR officer Anna and her superior officer Yasminka. Can we start the first town hall meeting next Wednesday? 2 o'clock. For the first town hall meeting, I would like to ask the group present here to prioritize, and to simplify my draft action plan, let's call it draft action plan, and maybe combine it with a school of business or a strategic plan. So what is the most important things and what needs to be done? On the strategic planning sessions, I was talking about going abroad, internationalizing, things like that. But then I come up with a strategic plan of 55 bullets and 35 sub-bullets. So can I ask you, as a special group, to draft a prioritization of what I drafted as a big plan and to tell all the others, look, we as a group, as a standing committee or sitting committee currently, we decided to redraft what Marek has suggested, and we focus on number one, number two, and number three, and KPIs will be this and that. KPIs for those who are not in business means key performance indicators. So, plan is a very simple thing. It is because we need to have classes and turn money out of it, and we teach it as a complicated thing to have strategic planning sessions. Basically, it just needs to tell us a few things. What needs to be done? Who will do it, when, and maybe how, and what resources are maybe needed. In this case, we start with 0 resources, of course. So can I ask this group?
Yes. But the main point about that action plan, which, you know, without going into details into the plan, is that you created parallel thing to our work plans, which are in final stage.
Okay, excellent.
And we might compare, we might kind
of... No, excellent. Well, this is why I mentioned once again. So I thought, to be honest, personally, I thought that when I say that this group will redraft and prioritize on action plan, I said that maybe combine it with the strategic plan and business, at least business plan.
Yeah.
So what I meant is, let's say actually match them and prioritize out of them what are the main issues and where can we focus. So I'm asking this group to do a little work in the next 7 days to meet at least once and to present your view of prioritization on the next of this action plan
business plan, strategic plan. Of course, now I will make another mistake if I say I ask the group, because who is the person in charge? So, most senior persons here are formerly Venera and Nikita, from what I can see, Daniela, and Yadranka, sorry. So, can I ask you, my dear ladies, to be the stand-up committee? And, excuse me?
All ladies,
yes. Well, we are, you know what was funny?
Men's world.
Yes, okay, so, can I ask our group of three to be the chairmanship? Is it okay, Professor, or we are still making mistakes? Maybe one person is in?
As long as I would love to see individual continue, not me seeing everybody just down his idea, then put something together. If we cannot put it together, fine. But
so, as I understand, every single person here should send me priority things that they think they're important from your action plan.
Or we can work the other way around. We
not necessarily. Not necessarily. That is one point of view. The second thing is that a person can say, well, this thing is completely wrong and we will drop it out of the action plan.
Okay.
Or pop it something else. The ideal solution, according to me, would be in the action plan we have, in strategic plan we have international students, or we have, let's say, increase the number of students from year 3 going to continue to year 4. That is, I'm for sure, that will appear in the strategic plan, in the business unit plan, and in this action plan. Let's see. Ideally, that would be the thing that we extract and focus on. Sorry, Ben?
To make things simpler, yes. Maybe considering the variety of everybody present, maybe the people should limit diversity. Sorry. Maybe we should limit to our faculties. And additional advices.
One of the things, Vera, you were not present on that meeting, which was joint meeting of NNS of political science, law and business. One of the things why town hall meetings have been invented is to get out of the silo vision. To be honest, a year and a half ago we were involved with that, the main point was integration. And then I received always feedback which was, we don't have eye of integration. Why? Because exactly of please don't take it personally at the moment, but we need to understand what the others are doing. Town hall meetings is like we're a small town in the Wild West and we all meet once a month and see what is new, whether we have desperados coming from Texas from Mexico to rob us or not, whether we'll provide whether we'll call the army to save us or not, whether we are developing or not. Town hall meetings, exchange of ideas, because currently I'm sure that you as a vice dean of IT school do not have a clear vision of what are business, what are called the learning outcomes which have been developed and adopted by business school. And I'm sure that architecture doesn't know that. On the other hand side, I'm sure that no one else knows how architecture had a beautiful strategic planning session. No strategic plans, team building before the new year, before the start of semester. And they had cross-examination of every course outline, who teaches what, where they are overlapping, if they are overlapping, why yes or why not. Sometimes they do intentionally overlap with architectural design group, with architectural design one, but that is to reinforce some of the things.
Simply try to organize things, meaning point A, faculties, point B, remarks in general, to simplify the things for the people who would have to synthesize the concept in the end. If everybody sends everything they think, there will be too much concept.
No, you need another meeting like this and lots of discussion.
I have two suggestions. One is, I take the responsibility of collecting all those priority lists, but two things. Either they can work as a group as they work on the case because they're good divided, you see architecture, law, administration, and then I can get one list of priorities from U5 and all of here. The other thing is I can collect individual lists and then I can.
That is a good suggestion. So we go into smaller groups like we were now. So you remember, okay, group one, who was presenting? Okay, then there is a team leader here. Group two, who was presenting, you're the leader. Group three.
3, who was presenting?
Veno.
You're the leader, group 4, Anna. And this is a good approach. We have a mix of... So guys, what is expected of you? And yeah, okay, then you...
So I sent the plan to the team leader.
Everybody has a plan.
No.
They are in charge to do the...
Not everybody.
Action plan was sent. Send it again.
Why would
we do this? Because Nikita is right that sometimes we are overlapping, and of course then it wouldn't be organizationally correct to intervene in the plan of which has already been adopted, past the procedure and all the other stuff. But where we overlap, then this is the place where we boost. Yes, other schools can be reset also. You're right.
So I should just collect 6 action plans from all schools.
So once again, you're right also about this. So Yasmina will send those for business. I'm seeing business unit plan because I know that they have plan correctly. For the others, I'm not sure. Yasmina will send. So very precise, who is doing what? Yasmina will send tonight to Eva if other schools have adopted plans. If yes, she will send the plans, if no, not. Eva will send to everybody, not in this room, to everyone again. Action plan, strategic plan, and whatever we have as a school plan. And you as a group, let's say you schedule, you have groups, and let's say you meet on Monday afternoon to discuss your prioritization of our combination of action plan, business plan, and strategic plans. Can we end the session now?
Yes.
Would you like us to see one powerful video?
Yes.
I was thinking about the coach. Thank you very much, of course, to Professor Nicolae. To Era and Anna, and especially to Iko and the technical crew, Eddie, and all the others who are there. And as would they say, as a boy, I believe that this is the beginning of a new friendship or a new way of thinking of GSCS. I hope that these town hall meetings will kind of change the way we do things and we'll have less disaster case strategies and much more efficient solutions. Who will give now the diplomas?
You
That was very straight for nonsense. Who, what, when, where are the diplomas? Professor, certificate of appreciation for you. One for me. But this is for this is certificate, this is for Professor Radev, Madame Yasmina.
Thank you.
Fala, mano.